The following is a KGSW-TV sports presentation. From University Stadium in Albuquerque, New Mexico, it's Lobo Football. Tonight, Channel 14 presents same-day coverage of the University of New Mexico Lobos against the University of Hawaii Rainbow Warriors. Lobo Football on Channel 14 is brought to you in part by Coors, the beer with a difference worth tasting. Coors is the one. Coors Light, the silver bullet. There's no slowing down with the silver bullet. Ajax Mobile Home, they've got the spirit, and it shows. Safeway, America's favorite food store. And by American Toyota, New Mexico's number one Toyota dealership.
Everybody, and a pleasant good afternoon from University Stadium. This afternoon, the University of New Mexico Lobos meeting the University of Hawaii Rainbow Warriors in a big whack college football game. In fact, it'll be the 13th meeting between the two institutions. Hawaii's played well when they've come to Albuquerque, winning here in two of their last three tries, and they lead the series 9-3. Hello again, Jim Lawwill here along with Gary Ness. And Gary, for the Lobos, they had a week off. Some time to mend some injuries, some time to get it together, and hopefully turn a page and start playing some winning football against Hawaii this afternoon.
Indeed, they wanted to improve their basic fundamental skills and their basic offense, but they also had an extra week to work on some things that are new. And Mike Shepard hinted this morning at a breakfast that he was going to take advantage of the fact that Hawaii comes from sea level here to play at Albuquerque at 5,000 feet. So we might look for him to operate his offense without a huddle. That would be some way to take advantage of that. And we also might see some things such as reverses or shuffle passes in their offense we haven't seen yet this year.
After 10 years, Dick Toomey left the University of Hawaii to become the new head football coach at Arizona. Dick Wagner is defensive coordinator now in his first year at the helm at Hawaii.
Well, and what Wagner wanted to do, he realized as defensive coordinator how difficult it was to stop Ben Griffiths' run-and-shoot offense. So Ben goes with Dick Toomey to Arizona. So what he did was pick up Ben's protege at Georgia Southern. So the Lobo fans will see a very familiar offense, the offense the Lobos have been using the past 2 years.
When you talk about Hawaii, synonymous with Rainbow Warrior football, Al Nanga, the All-American defensive lineman.
That name Nanga is big in Hawaii football. He has two older brothers who are playing for the St. Louis Cardinals. And there are 17 scouts, we've been told, from the NFL here to see Nanga play this afternoon. So that should tell us something.
All right, it's the University of New Mexico and the University of Hawaii hooking it up. We'll be back with a kickoff in just one moment. Back at University Stadium as New Mexico and Hawaii get ready to square off. There's the series matchup that we mentioned in our stand-up. Last year in Honolulu, Hawaii beating the Lobos 27-10 in that ballgame. Al Nanga, the All-American defensive lineman, took out tackle Steve Parr and Billy Rucker, the fine southpaw quarterback in that contest. It was a long evening in Honolulu for the Lobos that night. And Hawaii, Gary, has fared pretty well when they've come to the Duke City.
Well, they have. The last time I remember of them losing here was in the 82 season when the Lobos went 10-1, and that was a dramatic finish for the Lobos in that particular game. That was, by the way, on I believe that was on network television.
That was an ESPN game. There are the WAC standings. For Hawaii, this will be only their second WAC ball game. They're 2-2, 0-1 on the circuit, while the Lobos are 0-2 in the Western Athletic Conference, 0-4 overall. The Lobos will be in their home red jerseys this afternoon. Hawaii, the Rainbow Warriors, will be dressed in white. And they've dressed up University Stadium very beautifully again for this afternoon football game. Hawaii's going to kick the football off. Handling the duties will be Tracy Retkowski. And Retkowski was not kicking off until this ball game. He managed to earn the job. The Rainbow Warriors have been unhappy with some of the kicking by their place kickers, and they're searching to find the man they feel can do the job. Lobos receiving the kick. They'll move from left to right on your television screen. Back deep for New Mexico, Terrence Mathis and Thomas Crum. Tracy Retkowski to kick it off. We're just about ready to get it underway.
Will we see something different here, like perhaps a reverse on the return or a deep lateral? They've had 2 weeks to work.
Here's the kickoff. We're underway. They kick to Mathis. See if he brings it out of the end zone. He will not. And the Lobos start first and 10 at their own 20-yard line. Hawaii last week beat Yale 62-10. And here's the Lobo offense. McKay, Donaldson, Luther, Kalura, and Taylor, the offensive linemen. The quarterback, Barry Garrison, Tony Jones, Shane Hall, your running backs. And then the wide receivers, Terrence Mathis. Boy, is he having some kind of a season. Duff, and of course, Al Owens. Here's Garrison and the Lobos, first and 10 at their own 20. They'll run it a little bit. Tony Jones wanted to reverse it, fumbles. Looks like the Lobos got it back. Al Nonga came crashing in to force the fumble. Some big confusion, but the Lobos do retain possession of football, and there is a penalty marker down.
Now here, this is off of sweep action. It looks like a sweep going to the top of your screen, but Nonga, number 54, gets in there. Misses the play, but now there was no huddle by the Lobo offense.
Rainbow defense, Al Nonga, the All-American, Dana Directo, and Carroll up front. Good linebackers. There they are. Lalo is how you pronounce that guy's name, number 2, Eric Lalo. And then Saunders, McRae, Bell, and Norwood. A lot of experience in the Rainbow Warrior defensive secondary. Two of those, 4 3-year Lettermen. The penalty went against New Mexico, so it's second down and long for the Lobos. We'll call it 17 to go. Garrison to throw. Fires downfield, complete to Mathis. And Mathis spins across the 30, and he's out of bounds at the 32. A big gainer for the Lobos, and it's first and 10. William Bell on the stop for Hawaii.
This is the combination that has to work for the Lobos. You see Garrison throwing into the pressure there. It's a turnout pattern, and they put a slot back in there to take the coverage off of Mathis.
Garrison to throw it again. They're trying to set up a screen. Here's Tony Jones taking it up the field to the 40. 45 and out of bounds. Another first and 10 for New Mexico.
Without a huddle, and oh, what a block by Barry Luther. We may not have time to show you a replay, but Barry Luther, the center, got out there to turn the... All right, now watch for Barry Luther, 64. Well set up now. Out in front. Boom, there he goes on the quarterback. Gives him the space.
Gary told you the Lobos would work without a huddle, and they are right now. Nonga jumps off sides. It looked as if he jumped off sides. Lobos first and 10 at their own 46-yard line.
Now watch and see if there's any movement.
Dead ball, offside, defense, first down.
It was simply Nonga being too hasty. Two plays in a row now, the going without a huddle has helped the Lobos.
Inside Rainbow Territory, inside the 49. Garrison hands it to Tony Jones, and he's dropped for a loss. Rainbow's read that perfectly. Boy, for Hawaii, Lane Santiago came blasting in there. So making second and 6 now, just inside the midfield marker. Garrison has Owens to the bottom of your screen. Henderson to the top of your screen. Garrison the sideline, fires to Mathis, incomplete. Terrence had it, bobbled it, and lost it. William Bell on the coverage.
Bootleg action off of the sweep. They want Hawaii to look at a sweep play developing. Now once again, no huddle.
Third and 6 now for New Mexico. High backs behind Garrison this time. Mathis in motion. They flip it to Terrence. He'll spin across midfield. There he goes to the outside. First and 10, New Mexico. At the 38 of Hawaii. Well-conceived play that time.
That was a short, quick screen. But I believe Mike Henderson, there's the fake to Shane Hall. Just rear up, throw it out to the flat. Mike Henderson got the block on the cornerback, which breeds the mismatches.
Thomas Crum, a wide receiver in there now as well, as Garrison has it first and 10 at the Hawaii 38. Garrison with all the time, fires to Henderson, complete at the 14 of Hawaii. And the Lobos continue their offensive assault on the Rainbow Warriors. Rick Saunders with the tackle.
All right, let's look for a running back's block. Look at Shane Hall. Well, it's just barely out of your screen, but Shane Hall helped on Al Nanga, which gave Barry the time and the nice catch, leaping catch by Mike Henderson.
24-yard gain on that pass play. Time out on the field now. Looks like the Rainbow Warriors want to talk it over. So Hawaii thus far, Gary, has been unable to stop the Lobo offensive attack.
Well, let's give the Lobos preparation credit for that. The Hawaii, like most modern defenses, likes to change personnel, and going without huddle doesn't permit you to change personnel.
All right, we're going to take a break. We'll be right back. Lobos at the Hawaii 14, first and 10. Draw play to Shane Hall. He's to the 10-yard line. Gain of a little more than four. It'll be second down for New Mexico inside Hawaii's 10-yard line. Again, the Lobos will go without a huddle. And this maneuver has caused Hawaii some consternation. Garrison to throw again. Over the middle, nearly picked off, tipped. Maybe it is picked off. Hawaii claims they have it. This is the area where the Lobos have turned the ball over this season, and it is an interception for the Rainbow Warriors.
Now Garrison retreats. There are a lot of white shirts around the receiver, Mathis. I believe he was trying to get it to Mathis. It's just across the line of scrimmage. It was batted up, and any one of four different Hawaii defenders could have picked it up.
Dana Directo picked it off. There's the Rainbow offensive line. It's big. Warren Jones is the quarterback, trying to learn to run. The run and shoot, he struggled at times. Marco Johnson, a potential All-American candidate. Hey, Cody Fakava is a big running back, and Conn Smith and Chris Gaskill, the wide receivers. Jones now, out of the run and shoot, inside his own 10. That's Fakava, who dives to about the 13, and that'll be it. A gain of three for Hawaii. Now for the Lobos defensively, it's Kaneki, McCabe, and Edwards up front. They give up some size. Linebacking core of Orison Allen Martinez and Torrey Edwards. And then Randy Johnson, who starts with Marcel Weiss, Brett Heber, Darren Douglas, and you'll see Danny Lahr in there as they'll run with the nickelbacks defensively. Second and seven, Hawaii. Fakava again, off tackle for a gain of about three more. You told me they'd run the football. That's what they're doing.
Well, what they see is what we're seeing, five defensive backs by the Lobos. It's the same thing that Arizona saw. You don't try to throw the ball against five defensive backs, so they are staying on the ground. On the other hand, that's what the Lobos want them to do.
Fakava, who ran the football the first two times, rushed for 211 yards last weekend, and he'll take it again and has a first down, spinning and going past tacklers to the 25. So Fakava, who's 6'1 and 210, showed a lot of strength and power as he earned the first down. Marcel Weiss with the tackle.
And Warren Jones, their quarterback, deserves some credit. He read that. That is the veer option, and he saw the defenders fall off of Fakava and let him have the ball.
So the Warriors, who were deep in their own territory, first and 10 at their own 25. Jones to throw over the middle, incomplete, looking for Marco Johnson, but couldn't find him.
Brian McCabe was in there and giving him some pressure on Jones, and Jones wasn't near his receiver. You know, from the films we watched, Jim, this past week, Warren Jones, number six, has a lot of athletic ability, and he's at his best when he scrambles. But he seems to have difficulty making that quick decision that a run-and-shoot quarterback must make.
Mui Tolui, the big center. And Jones behind him. Little play-action fake, and the Lobos read that well. Fumble. Looks like an incomplete pass, according to the official. Lobos think they have a fumble and a recovery. Randy Johnson broke that up in high fashion.
Well, let's see if Danny Lara doesn't get a shot on here. Let's look and see. The pass is right in there. No, you're right. It's Danny Lara, I believe.
Yeah, Randy Johnson broke it up, I think, right? And then
he really was there on the receiver at about the time the ball arrived.
It is an incomplete pass. We assumed correctly. Third and 10, Hawaii. Jones to pass. Downfield, Marco Johnson, but again, I don't think they'll have the first. Whoa, what a mark by the official, and you can hear the crowd's reaction. So they will have a first and 10 on this one.
Well, I, from our perspective in the booth, I agree with the crowd. Warren Jones drills this pass in. That is a strong arm. Well, his feet did come down just inside the line, but you can assume that he was up behind the line or over the line when he caught it.
They assumed all right. Art Martinez with the tackle. First and 10, Hawaii. Jones keeps it.
Go D, get him!
He's got 10 and more out to the 48-yard line. That'll be a gain of 13 yards. Another first and 10 for Hawaii. Marcel Weiss with the tackle. That wasn't Warren Jones that time. That was Walter Briggs in at quarterback.
And I wonder why Walter Briggs, although he shows very quick feet there, Jones had that good strong arm and was getting the ball in there. I wonder why they went and changed with Briggs in the middle of a drive.
So here's Briggs. This time he fakes inside, pitches wide. That's MacArthur who dives over a tackler. Gain of about 5, that'll be it.
Good support, and he is mad at himself. Griggs is mad at himself because he pitched the ball too early. Now watch, he'll pitch the ball before anyone forces him to pitch it. See, he's still in the clear, and he makes his pitch. That allows the defense to recover to the pitch man.
Second down, 5 for Hawaii in Lobo territory. Now remember, they started this possession inside their own 10-yard line. Here's Briggs taking it left on the option, and he's getting a lot of space across the 30 all the way down to the Lobo 26-yard line. So the Warriors continue to drive, a 21-yard gain for Briggs that time. Briggs has been injured, Gary, but he's healthy, and they're ready to use him.
Well, and he gets the great block by the wingback who pins the nickelback, Marcel Weiss, inside, and that allows Walter Briggs. See, the cornerback, Troy Clewis, could not fold in on Briggs because there was a pitch man out there, and when you pin the nickel back, he's going to have room to run.
Briggs at the 26 of New Mexico. This time, that's Billy Stevens carrying the football. He'll get to the 18. So the Rainbows are chewing up yardage, and they're running the football.
This is the counter dive out of the wishbone offense. Turn around, and there's a tackle come back inside to trap block on that. Billy Stevens, 6'1", 210 pounds, hard to bring down.
Second and a short two.
Get up!
Okava tries the middle and spins and gets across the 10. He earned that first down. It'll be first and 10, New Mexico, just inside the 15-yard line. Hawaii with that big offensive front of 252, 262, 243, 250, 242. And right now, Gary, they're winning the battle at the line of scrimmage.
They really are, and they've had a good ball possession drive. They haven't mishandled the ball, and they've used two quarterbacks in this drive.
Briggs to keep it on the option. The 10, the 5, puts his head down and gets to the 1 of New Mexico. It'll be first and goal to go right there. Randy Johnson made the stop finally for New Mexico. Briggs is giving the Lobos some trouble with that option.
And he's out there because their slot backs are pinning the linebackers inside. There's no pursuit coming from inside out when the quarterback decides to keep the ball.
Well, the Lobos drove down, and we're knocking on the door, and Garrison threw the interception. Following the turnover now, Hawaii has driven the football down the field. They started inside their own 10, so they've gone 89 yards. Here's a dive play right side. Fukava tries for the touchdown, can't get it. Lobo is stacking them up well at the goal line.
And watch on the replay. Here's right at the line of scrimmage. Number 54, if we're running from the fullback spot to lead the play, is none other than Al Nanga. But even at that, the defensive front stacked it up and they didn't cross the goal line. But watch for number 54, the great defender of Hawaii. He'll be running out of the fullback spot. He'll lead the play.
He's the up back and the eye. This time they quarterback sneak it. Doesn't look like they got it that time either.
No, it doesn't.
Well, I'll tell you something about the Lobo defense. I don't believe there's been a series this season where they have given up.
Now watch how everyone tries to fight for low position here. Very few people raise up. The backs try to go over the top. But on the line of scrimmage, you struggle for low position. He tried to go over, but Art Martinez, you see Art Martinez hit him as he went over the line.
Briggs fumbles in the backfield. Lobos have a shot at it. They don't get it. Boy, what a scramble. Hawaii fortunate to get the football back. Now, that's the kind of thing that the starting quarterback, Warren Jones, has had problems with. And that time, Briggs nearly turned it over. Ron Valverde will come on to attempt the field goal, and the defense gets a well-deserved round of applause as the Rainbows drove 89 yards and were turned back. They'll have to settle for a field goal. Valverde to kick it. 25-yard attempt, long enough, good. So the Rainbows draw first blood. 6:53 to go in the first quarter. It's the University of Hawaii 3, New Mexico nothing. Stay with us. Be there. We want you to join us Halloween night.
Get your trick-or-treating done early. 7 o'clock kickoff. We'll be after.
Ratowski kicks it into the end zone again, and the Lobos start at their own 20. A drive that netted a total of 89 yards, a 25-yard field goal, kicked by Rod Valverde, in Hawaii leading it 3-0, but a valiant stand by the Lobos at the goal line to hold them to just 3.
Valiant is right, and you got to wonder if about that defensive front when they've got Al Nanga leading the plays and they can't score from inside the 5-yard line. That was some stand by the defense.
There's the drive. 16 plays, 25-yard field goal, 6.5 minutes nearly. Running the football, Garrison will be sacked at the 14-yard line. Al Nanga got him. Nanga has not had a lot of sacks this season, but there's a reason for that.
When you've got a defender like Nanga, people tend to double-team him. Now we see there, blocking on him is Guy Kalura, the least experienced of the offensive front, and he just manhandles Kalura and gets to the quarterback.
Second down, 14 for New Mexico. Movement in the line. And Nanga has Garrison on the turf. I don't believe, Gary, I've ever seen a defensive lineman that is as active as Nanga. He's more like a linebacker.
Well, they let him freelance some. He's such a great player. They let him line up just about anywhere he wants to. Now, I really believe what happened there was, I think Barry Luther snapped the ball because he thought Nanga was offsides, because there was no backfield movement or anything like that. But it did not work. The offsides was against New Mexico.
Third down now. Garrison to throw at his own 5. Now scrambling up the field and dropped from behind. As he gets to the 17, it'll be fourth down. We'll see the Lobo punting team and Steve Albrecht for the first time this afternoon. Lobos took the opening kickoff down, but Garrison threw an interception just inside the 10. Then Hawaii drove it down, sputtered at the 1.
Would you like to guess who it is that catches Garrison when he decides to run there? Number 54, Al Nanga.
Here's the punt by Albrecht. It's a beauty. Marco Johnson, great kick returner. Look at him. And he'll get up to about the 44. That'll be it. 50-yard punt by Albrecht. Steve Webster makes the stop for New Mexico.
You really have to corral Johnson, because if he gets beyond those first two sprinters downfield, he can cause a lot of problems for you.
Lobo football on KGSW TV 14 is brought to you in part by Coors Light. There's no slowing down with that silver bullet. Homecoming here in New Mexico, and there'll probably be a lot of Coors Light consumed after the ballgame. Here's Briggs going right. Wants to pitch, fumbles it again. Ball loose. What a scramble. Who's got it? Looks like Hawaii again. Boy, they've been fortunate. Briggs is pretty dangerous.
Yes, he is. And the Lobo defense is trying to force him to pitch the ball. Anybody who plays a triple option team, defensively your strategy should be make them pitch it. You see Orlando Lavelle take the dive, man. Right there.
Lobo's obviously adjusted.
Yes, yes. And they have to get help out on the quarterback. They have to get some inside pursuit on the quarterback. They can't let Briggs keep it off tackle like he did in the two big plays of the previous drive.
Second and 10, Hawaii. Briggs on a reverse. With the football, Larry Conn-Smith. He's got a first down and more. Finally out of bounds inside the Lobo 40. They'll mark it at the 39-yard line. So the Rainbows dig into the playbook. When we watched Hawaii on film versus UTEP, Warren Jones was the quarterback, and they didn't do that many trick-type plays.
Now, watching this, the action, everything's coming this way. It looks like the triple option coming this way, but the slot back takes the opposite course. Now, he has people waiting out there. He has two linemen waiting out there to kick him out. Lucky Danny Lara, Kirk Allen, got a hold of his shirt.
Boy, he sure did. Here's Fakava. Oh, fake to Fakava, and Briggs dropped for a loss.
Oh, that was good backside pursuit by Musa Kaniki. Oh, he was bearing down on him.
Kirk Allen in there.
Kirk Allen was the guy who made Briggs stop and hesitate so that Kaniki could catch him from his backside pursuit angle.
So the Lobo defense has made some adjustments. It'll be second down and 12 for Hawaii at the 42-yard line of New Mexico. Briggs, quarterback draw, and he nearly lost the football again. He waves that thing out there, and if I'm Bob Wagner, I might have a cardiac arrest by the end of the first half.
Well, he's going to make you or break you. Let's watch this. Now watch, I believe he wants to throw it. Yeah, he's looking for the short pass to the slot back. Now he's trying to gain some ground. Kirk Allen forces him wide there. Torrey Edwards had him, yeah, 47.
He tried to get the ball from him. He had it right out in front of him. Third down, we'll call it 9. Briggs in trouble. He's buried.
Torrey Edwards, I believe, was the first guy to have a shot at him.
Play, Orison finished him off.
Oh, that was a blitz. They had people coming from both corners. Let's watch for Torrey Edwards, 47 from the bottom. There you see him. He evades the block. Nice footwork by Edwards. And coming over the top from behind, Clay Orison.
Kyle Alouz, the punter for the Rainbows. He'll look to drive the Lobos deep in their own territory. Randy Johnson back to return the punt. Alouz, a left footer. The punt will sail into the end zone. Boy, I'll tell you something. That's really good work by the sound people. You could hear Alouz punt that football.
You could hear the thump.
Move the ball out to the 20. Lobos take over, trailing 3-0. 2:33 to go in the first quarter. Gary, thus far, both clubs have driven once. Fortunately for Hawaii, they could have committed a turnover but got the ball back. Unfortunately for the Lobos, they committed the turnover.
Yes. Hawaii could have committed two of them, but they've gotten the ball back twice on fumbles. But the Lobo defense has made some good adjustments on supporting on that triple option.
So here's Garrison. Split running backs behind him. Over the middle, Mathis. Breaks a tackle. 30, 35, out of bounds. Well, there's 17 NFL scouts here to watch Al Nunga, but they'll be taking some notes on Terrence Mathis.
You bet, and they'll be back in succeeding years because Mathis is just a junior, but he is some kind of football player, just as Nunga is as a defender.
No huddle again for the Lobos. There's your replay. And now back of the action with Garrison on the draw to Shane Hall. And Hall spins, breaks, tackles, and gets about 6 yards.
Nice feature on Shane Hall in the morning paper this week in the Albuquerque Journal. Talked about how he came into camp in great shape. And a lot of the Lobos and coaches were amazed at what he could do. Not blessed with speed or a lot of strength, but very hard-nosed kid. Second and short, Garrison straight back to throw it. Downfield has got Henderson out of bounds at the Hawaii 37-yard line. Garrison rifled that pass right on the money.
He certainly did, and Al Owens ran 40 yards right down the sideline to clear the area. Great protection. You don't see a white shirt in there. Art Valero's kid's doing a great job of protecting. No huddle again. The Lobos right here. They don't want Hawaii to have the luxury of substituting on that defensive front.
Mike Shepard telling me this week and this morning, the only thing that worried them about going without the huddle is during practices this week, sometimes after two or three plays, players would become confused about what play they were running. Garrison now fires it to Mathis on an ad-lib play, and it won't go. That was kind of the old pump fake, fire it and go, but it wasn't designed that way. They kind of ad-libbed, and it nearly worked out for them.
Well, this is what you call a quick screen. Now, this is supposed to be to Mathis, but Al Owens is outside. He wants to block him, but the linebacker came up inside. Actually, that might have turned out pretty well, but I think Barry did the smart thing in overthrowing it there.
Mathis with 46 yards and receptions already. Here's Duff. He has room. He'll have another first down. He's to the Hawaii 20. Just outside the Rainbow 20, William Bell with a stop. Lobos motoring down into scoring position again.
Bootleg action. Set the flow. They give it that sweep look going to the top and come back to the bottom. John Duff crossing the field. Hardest play to cover in pass coverage.
Wide receivers each side of the field. Here's Tony Jones on a delay. He breaks a couple of tackles and at least gets a yard, maybe two. Dana Directo has an interception in this contest. Pulls down the tackle to 6'3", 260-pound sophomore for Hawaii. Mathis top of the screen. You see him heading that way. Al Owens to the bottom of the screen. Second and eight. And there's Nonga jumping off sides. He is so aggressive.
He really is. And the Lobo strategy is taking advantage of it. You know, we talked about those cameras.
Dead ball. Offside. Defense. Second down.
We talked about the microphones picking up the punts and the sound of the punts. If the microphone was down there close enough, there's a lot of panning and heavy breathing going on among those big guys on both offense and defensive fronts.
Second down and three at the 14 of Hawaii. Garrison to throw it, setting up a screen to Tony Jones with blockers. He gets perhaps a first and 10 just outside the 10 of Hawaii. Eric Lalo came up to make the stop, and it was a saving tackle. He broke up what looked to be perhaps a big gainer, even a touchdown.
Yeah. It looked set up like it was going to go into the end zone, but Tony made one inside move too many, and he was slow getting outside, and pursuit was able to catch it.
There's Tony Jones right there. The measurement, first and 10 Lobos. We'll call it just inside the 11 of Hawaii. The Lobos knocking on the door. They trail it 3-0, only 43 seconds to go in the first period.
But they've been down here before, Jim, as you pointed out, and they turned it over. This is a chance for the Lobos to score and get the momentum.
So Garrison, straight back, fires in the end zone to Mathis, incomplete. He let him just a little too much. Terrence, who can flat motor, got his fingertips on it, but couldn't gather it in, and he was being pressured in the end zone by Kim McLeod.
So close, and Terrence has the wide side of the field to work with, one-on-one. You can't cover Terrence Mathis one-on-one with that much space, but the ball was just off his fingertips. So close.
Now, this is a passing down for the Lobos. Inside the 11. Garrison ready. Barry, little bootleg. He could run it. He'll throw an end zone touchdown. John Duff with a reception. The Lobos lead it 6-3.
The bootleg play. Crosser tight end against the flow. No, This works in the NFL, it works in college ball, and watch how open John Duff is. Everybody's down here covering Al Owens, and Terrence Mathis at the bottom of the screen, and there stands big number 84.
That's the Lobo fight song right there. Gary, you've heard it a few times, and up in the booth with us, Jimmy Williams, who will do the color for basketball. You two guys both heard that song a lot in your careers.
Yes, it's inspiring, especially after a touchdown.
Waltz with a PAT, 7-3. The New Mexico Lobos lead it. We'll be right back. The Lobos march 80 yards, consummate their drive with an 11-yard touchdown pass from Garrison to Duff. 9 plays, 2:07 to go 80 yards. That's quick. And 7-3, the Lobos lead it. Here's Albrecht to kick it off. Marcel Williams is the deep man, and he'll gather it in inside the 5. Here he goes to the 25 and dropped at the 26-yard line. Good special teams effort that time by Troy Cluis. Came downfield, made a fine open field tackle. 20 seconds remaining in the first quarter. New Mexico leading it 7-3. So Lobos, that has to be a confidence builder. They drove. They didn't turn it over. They got it in the end zone.
They did the hard work that time and then paid off by scoring the touchdown.
Walter Briggs is the quarterback for Hawaii. Briggs now will keep it on the option. Up the field, fires it. The trail back takes it. Lewis Lede goes all the way to the 43-yard line. That'll be a gain of about 17 yards, we'll call it. First and 10 for the Rainbow Warrior.
And Briggs executes this triple option perfectly. Now, he knows Musa Kaniki's behind it, but he knows he's out of the picture, and he waited until the cornerback, Randy Johnson, turned in on him and then used his pitch man very effectively.
All right, this time Briggs gives it to Cody Fukava, and he'll get a couple of yards, and that'll be it. Second and long for Hawaii.
What the Lobo defense is having trouble with is when their linebackers get pinned inside by the slot backs, and that's called a lead block on the triple option play.
All right, that's the end of the first quarter, and after one quarter, it's New Mexico 7, the University of Hawaii 3. We'll be right back. Stay with us now, won't you? Back at University Stadium, Hawaii now, heading the other way. Start of the second quarter, New Mexico leading 7-3. Briggs on the keeper across the 45, and then lassoed and dropped there. Kirk Allen and a host of Lobos in on the stop.
Kirk Allen didn't get pinned inside, and he was there to take the quarterback when he turned up the field, and it allowed the cornerback to stay on the pitch man. Much better defended there.
Hawaii came into this game 2-2. The Lobos winless thus far. Walter Briggs, the quarterback. Here's Fukava with a big hole. Look out. And he gets all the way inside the 40. That's a heck of a stop. Coming up and making the tackle, Brett Heaver. If he doesn't, it's a touchdown.
The Lobos were without a safety. And when you are without a safety and the play breaks on the line of scrimmage as it does, look, he's just running straight ahead. And there is that's going to be a big gainer.
They mark it just outside the 39 of New Mexico. So Hawaii charging right back. New Mexico leading 7-3. 15-yard gain on the play for Fukava and Hawaii. Briggs to throw it. Complete. Could be a touchdown. Touchdown. Marco Johnson broke over the middle, made the reception, a touchdown pass of 39 yards, and just like that, Hawaii jumps back on top.
Well, this is the pass play that Terrence Mathis caught so many times from Billy Rucker. It's the left-hander throwing it. It looks just like it. The same play that that Rucker and Mathis used so effectively a couple of years.
So Hawaii on top 9-7. Ron Valverde comes on to attempt the point after touchdown.
That's the quandary you catch the defense in. You have to expend your safeties to help you defend the triple option, and that means that somebody gets free.
The extra point is good. We're going to take a break. 13:49 to go in the first half. It's Hawaii 10, the New Mexico Lobos 7. We'll be right back. Tracy Ratowski kicks it off. Back deep for New Mexico, Thomas Crum, Terrence Mathis. Here's the kick. Mathis will get a shot at it. And inside his own five, heads upfield and gets to the 20 and is buried at the 20. Leon Austin was the man who got Mathis by the jersey and fired him to the turf. There's the Hawaii drive. Five plays. The big 39-yard touchdown pass from Briggs to Johnson. They did it in a hurry. A minute and 37 seconds. Hawaii leading 10-7.
Johnson, who received that touchdown pass, he's such a good athlete. He's a game breaker.
So Lobos now, first and 10 at their own 25. They're going to sweep it with Tony Jones. And Jones dives to the 29-yard line. Lobos are going to run a little more this afternoon. At least that's their game plan. Try to keep the Rainbows a little more honest so that Nonga can't tee off on every play.
And that sweep gives you the action. It gives the look to the defense that sets up the bootleg pass stuff. So that's important. Even though that doesn't gain, well, that gained five, well, long 4 yards. That's not bad.
Garrison, play action fake. Over the middle. Tipped, and Duff has it. That'll be a first and 10 at the 38-yard line. Looked like a Hawaii defender tipped it, and Duff grabbed it out of the air. We'll take a look at it.
This should be interesting because Duff was not uncovered. There are a couple of white shirts around him. Barry stepped in there, didn't have a lot of time to throw, but that was a great catch, and Duff's doing a better job today of hanging on to that football after he catches it.
First and 10, New Mexico. Garrison now, a little running play, and Tony Jones tries to get what he can out of it. Play just never materialized for New Mexico. Gain of a yard, it'll be second and 9. Hawaii has a player down on the play.
In fact, it could be Nonga. We cannot see his number there because Nonga has tied his shirt in a knot in the front, which the official warned him about at the start of the game, but evidently he still has it tied in a knot. The player who is down has his shirt tied in a knot, so...
American Toyota is proud to be a sponsor of UNM Lobo Football on KGSW TV 14. American Toyota, New Mexico's number one Toyota dealership. Hard to tell what happened there, Gary.
Yeah, it is. Unless I believe that is Nonga falling over. I think it was, he just fell over someone about the time the whistle was blowing, killing the play.
If your company or business is interested in a tent rental for UNM's two remaining home games, November the 7th against Wyoming, or November the 14th versus Air Force, there's Garrison. 10 for 14, 155 yards, 1 TD. That's good first half. Call Dick McKee at the UNM Athletic Department. Rent one of those tents and have a good time, as the Lobos only have two more home football games left. Gary, a lot of people ask me, why do the Lobos only have four home games this year? They play 11.
Well, they had five scheduled, but one of them was with SMU, who received the death penalty, of course, so their schedule was canceled, and it was replaced by an away game, the Arkansas game, at the conclusion of the season.
Second and 9, Garrison in trouble, scrambles, gets away, fires downfield, Duff complete, across midfield at the 48 of Hawaii, another first and 10.
Credit
Wayne Santiago on the stop.
Credit Barry Garrison for evading the rush. Now, there is a blitz from the backside. They have a secondary man, and just niftily evades number 9, gets the ball to John Duff. Pat McCray was coming with a blitz at the top of the screen.
We talked about how good Mathis's numbers are. There he is. Total offense, NCAA national rankings. He's first. Barry Garrison right there.
believe I said Mathis, and it's Garrison we're focusing on right there. Here's his pass over the middle to Scott Howard, in and out of the hands of Scott. It was thrown into traffic. It'll be second and 10 for New Mexico. It gives you an idea of the success Garrison has had this season.
It sure does when you consider number five on that list was Todd Sanis from San Diego State, who many feel is the best quarterback in the WAC Conference.
I want to remind you our next broadcast will be on Halloween the 31st versus UTEP. The Colorado State game, because of a problem with airing at the same time as the regional game of the week, will not be able to televise. We will televise the remainder of the schedule, including the UTEP game on the road and Arkansas. Garrison to throw over the middle, complete to Mathis. He's free. Look at him go. 20, 10, 5, touchdown New Mexico. The Lobos are back on top.
The defenses are taking a holiday. This is it. Now, Barry Garrison fakes the draw. Now he sees this is an adjustment, I believe, to blitz. And when he crosses the field and gets the ball, the two downfield blockers, Al Owens especially, you're not going to catch Terrence Mathis with that much field to operate in.
Quite a block by Owens at the five. Quite a number of blocks downfield. Rick Walsh, the barefoot kicker, to attempt the extra point. Is it good? It's good. 12-16 to go first half. Lobos back on top. Seesaw battle. They lead it 14-10. 14-10. Mathis with a big touchdown pass. And there is Terrence in the NCAA National Rankings all-purpose yardage, leading the nation, 204.25, 204 and a quarter yards per game. And we'll have his totals for you on this ball game in just a moment. And he is racking up some yardage this afternoon. Albrecht kicks it off, hits it good. Coldean Walls just let it land in the end zone. Hawaii starts at their own 20-yard line.
Just to follow up on that last graphic, Jim, you see Blair Thomas and Bobby Humphreys, Blair Thomas from Penn State and Bobby Humphreys from Alabama, number 4 and 5 in all-purpose yardage. That gives you an idea of how well Mr. Mathis has been doing, and he's certainly going to expand on that today.
There's the drive. Start on your own 25. Six plays, 75 yards, 48-yard touchdown pass from Garrison to Mathis. A minute 33. Briggs, the quarterback again. He'll run the option and pitch it to Lewis Lede, who gets to about the 25. That'll be it. A gain of 5. Check that. That wasn't Lewis Lede that time carrying the football. It was Marco Johnson. This UNM Lobo football telecast on KGSW TV 14 is brought to you in part by Safeway, America's favorite food store.
Kirk Allen had a hold of Briggs just as he released that ball, and just if he had him just a mite sooner, that pitch would have probably gone back into the end zone.
Movement all over the place. Briggs takes it. Musa Kanicki trying to rough Briggs up a little bit.
Saying, I'm sorry, but you need a ticket to get through here.
Well, we're looking at 5 the other way on New Mexico, although the officials started the wrong
dead ball. Offside, defense, second down.
Looking at that replay, it looked like Brian McCabe was the one who did cross the line of scrimmage.
The officials, there's Doug Toole, he's the referee in the white cap. John Bradley, Phil Euler, and Berdine Jarman. There are 3 others, and there they are. Caraway, Saraceno, who we had last time out, and John Robinson.
There is some sort of a discussion going on the far sideline. The linesman and the referee.
Well, with the 5 yards, I thought it would be a 1st and 10 for Hawaii. It was 2nd down on the penalty. They've got 3rd down. Now they flip it to 2nd. There is a Bob Wagner, the new head coach at Hawaii. That's 2 and 2.
Offside, defense, 2nd down.
Bob Wagner has a lot of respect for Mike Shepard and the Lobo program. That's been evident this week.
2nd and an inch. Briggs hands it off to Fukava. 1st and 10, Hawaii. Brick scares me the way he handles that football. Even when he hands it off, he's waving it out in the air. But he is an excellent athlete, and he can get outside and run the option.
It was almost like he didn't really want to execute that play, didn't it? Watch him just pull out from center here. In fact, he might have tossed that ball to Fakava.
Yeah. First down, 10 for Hawaii. Lobo's offsides. Briggs takes it. He'll be garnered around the 34. You don't see that happen that often. It's happened in two of the last three plays from scrimmage.
No, and the center for Hawaii is very quick to move out of his stance. And if I were the quarterback, I would say, hey, don't leave me standing here alone like this among all these defensive linemen.
Well, that's Charlie Mohutului. And Mohutului is 6'3 and around 250. So.
Offside, defense, first down.
Perhaps Briggs doesn't want to argue the point with him too heavily.
One thing for sure, the Lobos are not helping themselves by jumping off sides.
First and five, Hawaii at the 37 in Hawaii territory. Well, we got movement again all over the place.
And I don't believe this one will be the Lobos.
Now we got a little confrontation brewing. Kirk Allen, very aggressive player. And talking with Jack Stanton, the defensive coordinator, the other day, he says, you know, the Mexico State game we lost really hurts, but he says, after looking back on it, I know why we lost. Kirk Allen had a concussion.
Offense, first down.
And we didn't have him in the second half.
And he plays so much. You just watch how many times Kirk Allen, number 38, gets around the ball. If he makes the tackle or not, he turns the play in, or he forces the pass, or whatever he does, he's always around the play.
What are the odds of illegal procedure on this one? Here's Briggs rolling towards the sideline and doesn't get much. Maybe back to the line of scrimmage. Art Martinez leading the way for New Mexico that time.
In fact, this looks like a counter option play. No, it looks like a sprint out. It looks like a quarterback sprint out keep. In fact, I don't think they understood. I'm not sure they knew what they were doing there, because you would not run that type of a play into the short side of the field from the near hash mark, but that's what they did. I think there was some confusion there.
Briggs has carried the football now 12 times. They tell us Al Nonga still is not back in the ball game. Briggs in trouble, might have fumbled. Lobos say they've got it. This could be the big turnover New Mexico needed. They do have it. New Mexico has recovered the football.
And Briggs does not look like he knows what he wants to do with the ball. Now this is, the reverse is coming here, but now watch how he's looking at the defense. He's being tackled and trying to get rid of the ball. We may see Jones back in there, Warren Jones, on the next series.
I'll tell you. But Al Nonga has returned for Hawaii. Gary.
But what a turnover here for the Lobos.
He tries to underhand it like a softball pitch there when he's getting ready to hit the turf. Well, he's been waving the pigskin around all afternoon. This time the Lobos got it. Garrison has it. Throws downfield, complete to Duff. It'll be first and goal, New Mexico, at the 8-yard line of Hawaii. Great faking that time by Garrison. William Bell, Lane Santiago, sandwich Duff at the 8-yard line.
And this is the fourth time we've seen this play, the third time that they've completed it, once for a touchdown. It's a bootleg play. You fake the running action to the near side, roll out to the far side. The crossing tight end is going to be open.
First and goal, Lobos, at the 8 of Hawaii. 10-18 and counting remaining first half. New Mexico leading 14-10. Garrison straight back. Wants to throw. Shuttles it to Reggie Rogers, who's in trouble. I believe Nonga had him, lost him, but they'll drop him for a loss anyway at the 12-yard line. Leon Austin finally got him, but it was Nonga who messed up the play.
An interesting version here of the old Statue of Liberty, but instead of taking the back ball back over his shoulder, you see he holds it behind him for Reggie to take it. The cornerback is the player for the defense who stayed home and kept that from being a touchdown.
It wasn't Nonga, it was Sam Carroll pursuing there. So Garrison now second and goal outside his own 11, or the Hawaii 11, I should say. Garrison in the end zone. incomplete. Wanted Al Owens, had to overthrow it. The coverage was there that time. And Garrison alertly just threw the football away.
He wanted Al Owens from the time that ball was snapped. He knew he had single coverage up at the top, and that's the alley-oop type play. But Al Owens ran out of room. Big third down coming here. Look at that job by Guy Kalura there. Hey, that was a great job.
Timeout on the field. We're going to pause. 9:22 to go in the first half with your score. New Mexico 14, Hawaii 10. And it'll be a very interesting show. Join us here on KGSW TV 14. Garrison to throw, and he's buried, and a penalty marker dropped outside the 20-yard line. Boy, I'm telling you, that time the Rainbow Warriors pressured Garrison heavily.
The blitz is on here. The blitz is on here. This is a straight drop back. He ought to be able to get rid of that ball. Now, Shane Hall turns outside to help on Nanga, but they had too many rushers coming and not enough blockers.
Dana Directo saw. You got to turn on your microphone. Dana Directo saw that they were concerned with Nanga, and he came in and put a knock on Barry Garrison. So now it won't be an easy field goal for Rick Walsh. It'll be on the hash mark to the top of your screen. It'll be a 37-yard attempt. Lobos leading at 14-10. Garrison is the holder, so they always have an opportunity to fake it. Here's the kick. Oh boy, hurry up now. He missed it.
One good off to the right.
So, Gary, the Lobos had an opportunity leading 14-10, and they let this one get away, and it didn't look like he got all of that kick.
No, he didn't. It was spinning too hard, and it was from this angle, it looked like it might not have enough to get there, but it was also wide. Now, most sidewinder kickers, or soccer-style kickers, do like to kick from the right hash because there's a natural hook on the ball, but that ball didn't look like it had any hook on it at all.
Yeah.
The wind was slightly behind him, as you see the flags there. He had a tailwind, so conditions were right. He just couldn't get it.
14-10, New Mexico leads it. Walter Briggs brings up Hawaii at their own 20. Briggs spins, the southpaw's buried and sacked at the 16-yard line. The Lobo defense read it well. Brian McCabe was all over Briggs.
And the Lobos must continue to have that pressure on Briggs because his few passes out of the run and shoot have gone for big gainers, and he had a man running up the hash mark at the bottom of the field who was wide open, but Brian McCabe was there.
Second and 14. Marcel Williams, one of the wide receivers. Marco Johnson in motion. Counterplay to Lewis Lede. Lede gets away from one tackler, gets back to the line of scrimmage. Brett Heber came up to make the stop. Heber very astute at that tackling around the ankles, which you have to do if a running back gets any kind of room at all.
And which you have to do if there's a blocker on you, too. Brett Heber had to play off the block, and that was about all he could do, but he dove at his feet and got him down.
So Briggs faces a third down, and we'll call it 10 to go. With time to throw, Briggs. Now he scrambles, heads upfield, and McCabe gets him at the 16-yard line. Hawaii will have to punt. Good-looking sequence of downs by the Lobo defense.
Yes, now Brian McCabe catches him, and Brian McCabe looks like he's having a lot of fun playing football. There you see John Bell taking on the center. Now from this side, you see Clay Orison pursuing, and he turns, and Briggs had to turn up inside 47 Torrey Edwards for Brian to catch him. That's teamwork.
Kyle Alou is the punter for Hawaii. He'll take the snap from his own 1 yard line.
10 men on the line of scrimmage.
They nearly got it. Real short kick. It'll take a good roll though across midfield, and boy, pick it up in a hurry if you're going to. Tony Jones buried, or Randy Johnson, I should say, buried, but he needed to pick that ball up or make some kind of a decision or either get away from it.
Well, when you try to block the punt as the Lobos did there, they had 10 men on the line of field. Now watch this. Here they come. Now, they will get close to this. In fact, the snap wasn't handled all that well. Oh, so close.
41-yard punt, and he got a good roll on it, but he hit it end over end, and you usually get that good roll. Garrison in good field position, starts the drive outside his own 43. And the Lobos are going to reverse it, but Al Owens fumbles it and fortunately gathers it in back at the 34-yard line.
And from our angle in the press box, that reverse was wide open, and if he'd have just gotten this exchange right here, oh, if Al Owens, he had, with all of his speed, he would probably be waltzing into the end zone now.
The former track star was going to have an opportunity to show his sprinting ability.
Well, he fumbled the relay baton right there.
That's right. Second down and 20 for Garrison. Or around that. Barry, in trouble. Throws incomplete. Handle that situation well. There was nothing doing. Whatever the Lobos were trying to do, Hawaii took it away. The intended receiver was Reggie Rogers, and intelligently he didn't catch the ball. He just kind of knocked it down and kept it out of play.
Well, unfortunately, one of the Hawaii linemen also read that as a screen, and he was all over Reggie Rogers, wouldn't let him release. We could see the lineman get out there into the flat, but without a receiver. So Garrett Berry had nothing to do except try to run and buy time. By then, it was too late, so he just flipped it at Rogers' feet.
Shotgun formation for New Mexico. Garrison gives it to Shane Hall. Hall gets to the 40. That'll be it. That'll bring on a punting situation, or bring up a punting situation for New Mexico. Send out Steve Albrecht and the Lobo punting team. 6:05 and counting remaining first half. New Mexico leads 14-10. Marco Johnson, the All-American candidate, back to return the punt. He'll stand around the Hawaii 15. Albrecht booms it. Johnson takes it at the 15. He's troubled if he gets free. 20. And now dropped from behind at the 24 by Troy Cluis. Cluis has had two fine special team tackles this afternoon.
You know, interesting thing, Troy Cluis, number four, running off the field, he's kind of taken Thomas Crum's place as the ace kickoff and punt coverer, because Thomas Crum is backing up Terrence Mathis now as a receiver and seeing much more time as a receiver. But there's Troy Cluis acting like Thomas Crum.
Albrecht, the punt, 47 yards, so he has punted twice for a total of 97 yards. He's been hitting it well. Here is Billy Stevens right up the middle, and he'll get to the 31-yard line. A gain of almost 7 for Hawaii. The Rainbow Warriors like to run it. The Lobos like to pass it. New Mexico leads 14-10. Walter Briggs. Second and four, we'll call it. Here's Hikoti Fakava. No, that's Billy Stevens. And Stevens gets close to the first down. Might be a yard short. Lobos closing in well. You can see John Bell, the Del Norte product, in there, along with Kirk Allen to make the tackle.
Now watch, this is what they call the veer out of the triple option. The first part of it, sometimes called the dive. But you must stop at 1, 2, 3. You must stop the veer first, then the quarterback, then the pitch.
Third and a yard. Briggs takes it. Fakes to Stevens, heads up the field, keeps it, has the first down to the 39. So Hawaii first and 10. 4.5 minutes to go in the first half. Art Martinez with the tackle for New Mexico.
And Art Martinez is limping off the field right now. It'll be a loss for the defense if he's not able to continue. He is on his feet, however, and looks like he may have turned his ankle slightly or something. Replaced by Chris Houston.
Briggs, 16 carries, 36 yards, and a touchdown to his credit. Fumble. Rainbows get it back. Holdeen Walsh was going to carry it, but again Briggs handed the ball off and hit him up in the chest around the numbers.
Let's look at this handoff here. Now Briggs is going to reverse out, There, it looked like it was there. You know, we've seen more fumbles today, Jim, I think, than we've seen all season on both sides. I don't have an explanation for it.
Briggs kind of just pushes the ball at people. Had a shot of the Lobo band. They're getting ready to entertain at the half.
Get him.
All right, scrambling Briggs up the field. He's a real good athlete. He's at the 40 and out of bounds at the Lobo 26-yard line. In fact, they're going to put it out at the 24. So we talk about Briggs and the fact that he kind of throws the ball around, but the one thing he can do is run with it if he gets some open space.
Yes, it is. And somebody here cuts off Kirk Allen. This is Kirk Allen's man there. You see, he's behind, and Briggs is just too fast. Just too fast.
How about the way Briggs is handling that ball when he's heading towards that line of scrimmage? He has that thing out there waving it around. Somebody might take it from him.
He has a lot of confidence in himself.
That's a nice way to put it.
He makes his offensive coordinator have nightmares, but...
At the 24 in Lobo territory, Briggs fires, incomplete. Boy, he had his man. It looked like the ball was catchable. That was Chris Roscoe trying to make the reception.
It's almost predictable. When you can't get your middle linebacker to stop the quarterback, you have to move your safeties up to help on the triple option. And when you do that, you're going to come, that leaves single coverage on the wide outs, and they're going to come with that slant in pass because there's no safety to stop it.
So Briggs now at the 24, second and 10 in Lobo territory. Lobo's leading 14-10. Briggs pitches. They go wide with it to Walsh. He has good speed outside. He has a first down. He's out of bounds at the 11 of New Mexico. We watched Walsh on film against UTEP, and a couple of times when he got outside of all the Hawaii running backs, probably not the most physical because he's not that big, but certainly when he gets outside, probably the most dangerous.
Now Marcel Weiss, number 20, has a shot at him here, but he makes Marcel Weiss stand up. And he's so fast that once you stand up on him, Walsh is going to beat you around the corner.
So first and 10 Hawaii, outside the 11 of New Mexico. Final score in the American League Championship Series, Detroit 7, Minnesota 6. So Twinnies still up 2-1. Here's Stevens with room at the 5, nearly has the touchdown. He'll be close to a first and goal situation around the 1-yard line. And it's the third time in the first half that the Hawaii offensive line has been able to open up the middle for Fakava or Billy Stevens.
And right now the defense looks tired, and in comes number 54, Al Nanga, who's going to be leading these plays. Now they pull the guard. This is a trap play. Kick out on Musa Kaniki. Well blocked by the Hawaii offensive front there.
They are 1 inch short, Gary, of the first and 10 with the ball resting around the 1-yard line. So it'll be second down and about an inch, but they'll probably be thinking touchdown right here.
Oh, yeah, you've got to play goal line defense here. Anytime you have less than a 2-yard average per down to get in the end zone, you have to go with your 6-5 goal line defense. Now, once already today, we've seen the Lobos stop them right here and force them to kick a field goal, but let's see if they do it again. Follow number 54, the fullback in the offensive set, Al Nanga. He'll show you where it's going.
Briggs has it. That's Fakava. Touchdown, Hawaii. So the Rainbow Warriors are back on top, 16-14, as the ball game continues to seesaw back and forth. Homecoming for the Lobos. There's Fakava.
Boy, look at the takeoff by the offensive line. There's Big Nanga right there blocking on Kirk Allen, I believe. And Fakava just leaps over the line.
Here's the kick. Valverde hits it pretty well. It's good. And so the teams will head up the field with only 3 minutes to go in the first half. Your score now, the University of Hawaii 17, the University of New Mexico 14. Aloha, Hawaii, from the University of New Mexico. Aloha can mean hello or goodbye. Right now, the Rainbows on top 17-14 as Petowski kicks it off. Terrence Lance Mathis. What a crushing tackle on the special teams to drop him at the 20. That was Mark Odom who came in with a crushing tackle. Why is it, Gary, that the Lobos try to run wide on so many kick returns instead of taking it straight up the field?
Well, they have been taking it straight up the field up to now, but this is the second time today they've tried to take it in front of their own bench. You know, it's a thing like being a favorite, like being right-handed or left-handed. You like to run plays in front of your bench, and that's where they've had the wedge go today.
There's the drive, 76 yards, 9 plays for Cava with the 2-yard touchdown run. Here's Garrison, incomplete, wanted Mathis on a curl in. Terrence curled in, the pass curled out. And it's 2nd and 10 for New Mexico. Back in fourth game.
Barry Garrison took a heavy hit from Sam Carroll on that play. In fact, he's having to leave the game. No, he started off.
The Lobos took a timeout, or... Yes, they will come out and take a look at Barry Garrison. As Gary astutely noticed the hit, and it was a very brutal hit on Garrison. Duffy Doherty, the freshman, may see his first action.
Looks like trainer Larry Woolick is looking in his eye. I don't know if Barry wears contacts or not. Do you, Jim? I don't think he does. Or he might have just gotten a finger poke in the eye, but that looks like what Larry Woolick is attending to there.
Usually, when someone wears contacts, if you wear them, and I do at times, you can tell because you notice them on the eyeball. And from being close to Barry, I've never noticed it, but you never know. I'll tell you, those contacts can give you some trouble. Maybe he got it across the bridge of the nose, too. We know that can happen. Duffy Doherty, here comes the freshman. No relation to the former great coach, now deceased at Michigan State, Duffy Doherty. He tells you I'd like to be related to him, but I'm really not.
What a name for a football player.
So let's see if they let the freshman put it up in his 2nd and 10 in his debut. Now Tony Jones will try the run, and Al Nunga is right there. So Doherty, the freshman, takes the snap, turns around, and who is closer to him than the man he's going to give the football? Al Nunga. What a way to get baptized.
That is. And I believe Barry Garrison is coming onto the field again. There we see Duffy.
Nice debut, Duff. There you go, buddy.
Standing there next to Coach Mike Shepard.
So Garrison, 3rd and 12 now at his own 20. Time running out, first half, 2:15 and counting. Hawaii leading 17-14. Garrison in trouble, throws it incomplete. And they're going to call, I think, roughing the passer on Hawaii. Looked like Nunga got a late hit on Garrison, or it could be the old intentional grounding.
The old intentional grounding. It's going to be hard to see. He did take quite a hit. We'll see what happens here. That's what it is.
Roughing the passer. That's a costly mistake by Hawaii, Gary. They would have had the football back with over 2 minutes to go, or perhaps 2 minutes to go in the first half, leading. Nunga wants an explanation, and I was telling you, I think maybe he really wanted a gimmick. Hawaii could bring him out in a truck in a cage, because that's the kind of reputation he has, as really being a real hard hitter and aggressive.
Initial grounding, offense, loss of down, fourth down.
So it was intentional grounding.
Well, now in this situation, the punter, Albrecht, cannot step back. He's going to line up a yard inside the end line, and he can't step back, or it is a safety.
He'll hurry to get it off, and he does. End over end. Hawaii is going to have great field position. Marco Johnson at the 40 with room, 35, 30, and at the 28, the Lobos finally get him. So Hawaii leading it 17-14, 2:01 to go first half, and now they've got it in excellent shape at the 28-yard line of New Mexico.
Now this is a real challenge here for the defense, because your situation is you don't want to let them score again before the end of the half, and so your defense has to pull the stopper right here. If not, Hawaii has the momentum, and you can go in feeling like the game is slipping out of your hands if you're a Lobo. This is a test.
Warren Jones is at quarterback this time as Rainbows have rotated Jones and Briggs, and this time they'll go with a Koti Fukava, and he is very near a first down inside the 20 of New Mexico. And that bigger offensive front for Hawaii is starting to take control of the line of scrimmage again.
And they're going into their two-minute offense with Jones. Jones, I think, is basically the passer, and I think Briggs must be basically their runner at quarterback position.
Well, Jones handles the ball a little more smoothly than Briggs. They're going to measure, Gary.
They were ready to go without a huddle. They do get the first. Ah, this is a tough spot for the defense. But if they can keep them out at this point, I look for the Lobos to really come back strong. If they don't, it's going to be tougher.
So outside the 18 of New Mexico, Warren Jones, the junior quarterback, with a first and 10. Lewis Lede in motion to the top of your screen. And again, they try Fukava, who somehow finds room. He could be in there for the touchdown, and he is. So Fukava, with just some fine extra effort, takes it in, an 18-yard touchdown run, and quickly, Hawaii enjoys their biggest lead at 23-14.
Okay, now, the pursuit runs by him on the line of scrimmage. Number 38, Kirk Allen, you'll see cross in front of him there, and you'll see he'll get behind Kirk Allen and right up through the middle. And once he gets ahead of steam, there he's very difficult to bring down.
You can hear the crushing strength of Fukava right then as he scored. Here's the extra point, and it's good. Valverde connects. So 1:40 to go in the first half, and Hawaii leading at 24-14. And Gary, this is how Fukava does it, and he does it a lot on his own.
Now see him stop right suddenly there, and two Lobos run by him. Orlando Lavelle tries to drag him down, but he's just too strong.
So the Hawaii Rainbows, who trailed 14-10, now lead 24-14. This ball game looked like it was going a Lobos' way, and Hawaii has caught fire. There's a 28-yard drive. Fukava runs the football on the two plays, the final being a 17-yard run, the first being a gain of about 10. We'll give him 11, I guess. That makes 28. That's good, Jim. Here's the kick. Ratowski hits it, and up the field with it, Terrence Mathis with a little bit of room to the 40, into the 43-yard line. Now with a minute and a half to go in the first half, the Lobos will have to get in that hurry-up offense.
Now, Jim, we were talking about why they bring it up on the far sideline, but he breaks it here. Now, the kick brought him to the sideline. He catches it just inside the sideline. There's Guy Kalura out front, David McKay, a couple of starting offensive linemen with blocks. And, boy, he just needs a seam, and then he darts through it with his great speed. Jeff McDonald out in front.
Gavin Robertson finally caught him. First and 10 Lobos at the 43. They trail it 24-14. Timeout called. It's like Hawaii took the timeout. They want to talk it over. They don't want to make any mistakes with 1:31 to go in the first half. Now the Lobos led it 14-10. But since then, Hawaii has put together a couple of drives, and they've basically done it by going to the running game and by simply dominating the line of scrimmage.
But you know, if there's a turning point, Jim, it was then when the Lobos got the fumble, Briggs fumbled, but could not convert it. That the Lobos could have really maintained a handle on the game right there. It could have been theirs.
All the way.
And they did have the field goal opportunity at least, but they couldn't get it. Their NCAA national rankings. This is receiving now. Terrence Mathis, second in the country. You can see the company he's keeping there.
Receptions per game.
He's got four passes in this contest. Total of 94 yards and receptions on four passes for Terrence.
Put it on straight.
So he's right on course.
There you go.
And he was leading the nation in yardage per game.
Garrison going deep. Incomplete, nearly picked off. They wanted Mathis, Gary, but It looked like it was covered perfectly out there by Rick Saunders.
That's the first time they've gone for the home run or the bomb, whatever you want to call it, tonight. Mathis has been running across the field underneath coverage, dropping him the ball and letting him get what he can. But this time, they just tried to see if he could outrun the cornerback, but actually they were caught in a two-deep with two safeties, and the safety did not let him free.
Hawaii leading at 24-14, 1:26 to go in the first half. Second and 10 for New Mexico at their own 43-yard line. Looks like they're going to change footballs.
All that rain we've been having, it's too wet.
25-yard field goal, got Hawaii on top. Then Garrison to Duff for a touchdown, and the Lobos were on top 7-3 in the football game. All right, there's that bootleg again. Garrison looking downfield, complete as Al Owens across the 40 and intelligently out of bounds at the 36 of Hawaii. Fans wanted a late hit, and they don't get it. Leon Austin over there on the stop.
Well, it's not so much a late hit, but you're not supposed to hit him out of bounds. Here's that bootleg action, which has been so successful and so frustrating to Hawaii. Now, the thing that Al does here, as you said, intelligently, he gets out of bounds.
Well, the Lobos led 7-3, then a 39-yard pass from Briggs to Johnson, 10-7 Hawaii. The Lobos' Garrison to Mathis for 48 yards, lead it. And then the two drives by Hawaii, they lead it 24-14. Lobos trying to drive down and get something before the half. Here's Tony Jones. Boy, he could have gotten out of bounds, but he elected to stay inbounds. He got a few more yards. Penalty marker hits the turf. 1:07 to go. Clock stopped. 24-14 Hawaii.
You're right. He could have gone out of bounds. He would not have gotten close to the...
It's going to go against the Lobos.
That was sure a late flag to be calling a clip.
And the head referee, made the call.
I'm not denying that a clip didn't occur, but there was sure a late flag to be calling a clip.
Clipping! Offense! First down!
It appears that Terrence Mathis was hurt on that play.
All the way, Lobos.
He limped off the field. Here come the Lobos now. First down and 20. That penalty hurt them. Everybody jumps off sides. We'll sort this one out. We had a stint like this in the first quarter as well. All right, this is what happened to Mathis on the play, Gary.
Dead ball.
You're seeing double coverage.
Defense. First down.
You're seeing double coverage here. Now, the defender's going to try to force him out of bounds. Now, Mathis can still come back in. Oh, my golly, he really forces him out of bounds. Into the bench.
All right, Garrison to throw. Now he's in trouble. Fires complete to Shane Hall, but he's hit and dropped after a small gain. Couple of yards. 45 seconds and counting remaining first half. Here's a score, a bit of surprise, Gary. Well, maybe not to some people, but at almost halftime, University of Washington Huskies 17, Arizona State ranked 7th, nothing.
Well, I know that pleases you, being an old Washington grad.
Well, they were having a good season. They got upset last week. Looks like they came to play today. And Mathis catches it out of bounds inside the 20.
Beautiful pass by Garrison. Lots of time. Nice job by the offensive line. And a good pattern, an outside pattern. Mathis has not run many outside patterns today.
And we'll have some other scores for you at halftime. Only 24 seconds remaining in the first half. The clock stopped. First and 10, New Mexico, just inside the 20-yard line.
In actuality, this is the area of the field that New Mexico has been most effective scoring from. It's when they get inside the 10-yard line that they've had difficulty scoring this year, so 24 seconds may still be ample time.
There's Garrison. Look at the numbers. 17 of 26, 285 yards and two touchdown passes. But on the scoreboard, it's Hawaii 24 and the Lobos 14. The Lobos take a timeout. Now, what are they going to talk about right here?
Well, first of all, let me say that was a strange timeout. It didn't look as though Barry Garrison wanted that timeout, but somebody called it, and because he turned around and discussed with the official as he walked off the field something like, hey, I don't want a timeout. But anyway, it's first and 10 here. What they'll probably do, we got two conferences in the offensive line are going to try to talk about different stunts they're liable to see. Basically, the receivers have to know to get outside out of bounds, try to stop the clock because of the clock situation. And, you know, this would be an opportunity right here from about the 20-yard line in to use a play that we haven't seen, such as a shuffle pass or a reverse.
For the best in entertainment, turn to KGSW TV 14 weeknight, starting at 5 with 2 hours of comedy, including the Emmy winner Michael J. Fox in Family Ties at 6. See it all here on KGSW TV 14. You saw the graphic on Mathis, 5 receptions, 136 yards. And there it is, weekdays on The Great Entertainer. Lobos would like to get in the end zone here, at least get a field goal out of this. Garrison at the Hawaii 20. Mathis in motion. They're probably looking for him. Garrison with time. Over the middle. Duff, touchdown. Penalty marker dropped. This could be offensive interference. We'll wait and see. You just never know. Hopefully it'll go against Hawaii. Garrison delivered that ball right on the money. No, it's interference on Hawaii. Touchdown stands.
This is some pass by Barry Garrison. Now, they put Mathis in motion, and he's running up the left hash mark. The tight end, John Duff's running up in the right flat. And so he's going to be open. Now, the thing about Duff is he gives you that tall target. He's 6'6" or close to 6'7". And for if you're going to throw against him, you throw the alley-oop. That ball was thrown perfectly.
Rick Walsh will attempt the extra point. 24-20. Lobos trying to draw within three, and the kick is up. It's good. Penalty markers are dropped. 19 seconds to go in the first half. Hawaii leading 24-20. A very big score for New Mexico here in the waning moments of the first half.
Indeed it was. Evidently the penalty will be against Hawaii and refused. Okay. We're going to see another angle of this touchdown. You see part of the homecoming crowd. Now this is field level from the opposite corner. Just flashing across your screen there was 15 Terrence Mathis. He draws the safety. That leaves the cornerback on tall John Duff. And here's the ball up in the air. Now the cornerback's really trying to hold John Duff because he knows that if it's a high pass, there's nothing he can do. Safety there is trying to go over, but he's already late.
So now Lobos prepare to kick it off, and with 19 seconds to go, Hawaii has two options. They can...
Illegal participation, defense, extra points good, on the kickoff.
In other words, 12 men on the field.
Yes.
I don't know why they just don't say that.
Well, there may be other ways you can participate illegally that we don't know about. But
yeah.
12 plays. Actually, you know what happens in that? Another way of illegal participation would be if somebody's... The old Tommy Lewis incident, you know, when Dickie Mayo's running down the sideline and Tommy Lewis comes off the bench to make a tackle, that too is illegal participation.
And there's the drive. Lobos did it in a hurry. 1:21 puts them right back in the ball game. And, of course, the touchdown, 19 yards from Barry Garrison to John Duff. Garrison has over 300 yards passing, if my memory serves me correctly, and we're only in the first half of the football game.
This has not been what you'd call a defensive standoff, but it's an exciting game, and that touchdown, as you said, Jim, gets the Lobos back in it.
This now, is the kind of kickoff you love if you're the kickoff man, because you're going to kick it from the 35 of Hawaii. Here you might just try to punch it at somebody and force a quick turnover, one would think.
Sure, some form of an onside kick. You can pull out your bag of tricks here, and let's see what the Lobos do. See number 25 in the huddle there, Jeff McDonald? If I were going to execute an onside kick, Jeff McDonald's the type of guy who isn't afraid to get down and get under the ball. And in other words, run right into the opponent's players to get after that ball. Watch number 25, Jeff McDonald.
Yeah. Well, I'm watching him so far, Gary, and he's still in the huddle.
He's easy to see, isn't he? All right,
here it is. Well, they got a shot at it, but they couldn't get there in time. Not a bad job by Albrecht. He kicked that one pretty much the way you want to.
Well, they were hoping to catch Hawaii napping. The dangerous thing about that is if somebody from Hawaii picks that up and runs back to the far side of the field, there's no one left to tackle him or drive him out of bounds.
So Hawaii will have it at their own 24 with 19 seconds to go in the first half. They lead New Mexico 24-21. Here it is.
Now, see, what you've got here is a cluster of people trying to cover the kickoff. Now, that gives you a better chance at recovering it, but it puts you in a poor situation to cover them once they do it.
Jones scrambling in the backfield and finally lassoed by Kirk Allen and will be dropped. Time running out. That will probably be the last play of the first half. We're down to 8 seconds and timeout called. So Hawaii will try one more time, figuring you never know what might happen. They've got 8 seconds left. There's your score, 24-21. The next time we do a ball game from this facility, they'll have a new scoreboard at the south end of University Stadium. State of the art, in fact. Should be interesting to see that.
Fans have had an interesting game here today. 45 points and still the first half.
Ajax Mobile Homes and KGSW TV 14 team up to bring you Lobo football in part. Ajax Mobile Homes, they've got the spirit, and it shows. It's homecoming at the University of New Mexico. Lobos take another week off, then go to Colorado State. It will be the only game we do not telecast this season because it will be in the same time frame as a regional game, and therefore we get the curtain. But we'll be back with you Halloween night from El Paso for the New Mexico UTEP clash, and what a story UTEP has been thus far this year. They'll run it this time with Billy Stevens, and he'll go up the field across the 45, breaking tackles all the way to the Lobo 41. So that'll pad the stats of Billy Stevens, but that'll be it. The first half is over. The two clubs head to the locker rooms, and we've got a very interesting football game. Your score at the half, Hawaii 24, New Mexico 21. We'll be back with halftime stats. Take a look at the Lobo band and have scores. Back at University Stadium, Jim Lawwill here, along with Gary Ness. Gary, 24-21 Hawaii, as we get ready to start the second half. And it'll be important to see who will be able to move the football and tally first as the second half gets underway.
Well, we thought it would be much more of a defensive game than it is. Hawaii coming in here with a much touted defense, and the Lobos knowing they would have to play good defense to stay in the game, but instead it's turned out to be an offensive battle. Both offenses have been running up and down the field. So there you see, I think her first name is Amy, but her last name is Wilcoxon. She's the homecoming queen. No, it's not Morgan Fairchild.
It's not your girlfriend either, is it, Gary?
Oh, my goodness, no.
Well, that's part of the magic that is homecoming in any college campus. Gary talked about Hawaii's defense. How good are they? First in the WAC, sixth in the country. But they've given up 21 points. As the Lobos have tallied 21 times, but trail at 24-21. Lobos kick off to start the second half. Hawaii will take it and move from left to right on your television screen. Marcel Williams is the deep man for Hawaii. Here's the boot, squibs it. Louis Lede picks it up. 25, Lede can fly 30 to the 34. So Hawaii will open it up in good field position at their own 34-yard line, leading it by a field goal as we get underway here in the third quarter of action.
Well, both defenses now are rested, and the Lobos need to try to keep them pinned in and so force them to punt to regain any field position out of this.
Opening at quarterback will be Walter Briggs. It's been he and Walter Jones, or rather I should say Warren Jones. Briggs breaks free, and he's into Lobo territory all the way to the Lobo 43-yard line. Brett Heber caught him from behind.
This is a counter option series. He'll turn out to his left, fake, and come back to his right. Got a guard pulling out in front of him, but he just sees daylight and he can stop. He's so agile. It's not his overall speed so much as his agility that gets him free.
Briggs now fakes it, keeps it, heads up the field, 35, all the way to the 30. Another first and 10 for Hawaii. So the Rainbow Warriors, who netted nearly 300 yards on the ground in the first half, start out the same way in the second half, moving it via the ground attack.
Exactly the same play, but mirrored now, running it to the left. And there he goes, getting another good game.
I'd like to see somebody try to take that ball from Briggs, Gary. He sure has it out there where you might be able to strip it.
Yes, he does.
All right, they try the middle this time with Fukava, and the Lobos read it well. Kirk Allen just took on the big running back and brought him to the turf after the gain of only a yard. Second and 9 for Hawaii.
Hawaii looks like they would rather run options from counter option action rather than just straight option. In other words, opening to the same side, executing all three options to the same side. They like to misdirect the middle linebackers first.
There's Fukava, 12 carries, 71 yards. Quick snap, and penalty markers are thrown. Now, Hawaii is kind of clapping and cheering, and I don't understand why. I see why. It's going to go against the Lobos. That surprises me, Gary.
Well, the center is taught, if you see...
Second down.
And the center is in perfect position to see when anyone penetrates the neutral zone, over the ball, in other words, then he snaps the ball, regardless of the snap count, he is to snap the ball, thereby creating somebody in the neutral zone. They are offsides.
So Briggs now with second and 5, and he'll be buried in the backfield. Looked like they were going to try to run that play for the third time with a fake inside, and Briggs kind of picks his way down the line of scrimmage and heads upfield, but Brian McCabe was right there that time for New Mexico.
You're exactly right, but Brian McCabe got through the seam, and actually he was at the fake or exchange point, so he really kind of tackled both people right there. That's a good way to stop that. Lobo should keep trying to do that. Control it with their men on the line of scrimmage.
Loss of a yard, third and 6 for Briggs. A southpaw to throw, dumps it off. Taken, and Fukava up the field, has a first down, breaks tackles. He's a load to bring down. He's inside the 20 at the 18, Art Martinez, and a host of Lobos finally bring him down. Once Fukava gets ahead of steam, it's very hard to tackle him.
And indeed, what had happened there? Now, Kirk Allen is blitzing, 38. He's right in his face. Briggs does a great job to get it off and into Fakava's hands. Now, Kirk Allen would normally be the person in that area to guard him, but since he was expended as a rusher, that's why Fakava gets the yardage.
75 in at the offensive right guard position for Hawaii, and he is a 325-pounder, Mark Nua. And here is Coldine Walsh on the option across the 15 to the 14-yard line. So the Rainbow Warriors in the second quarter were getting a lot on first down, a lot of real estate, and they're doing that again here in the early going. Remember, they lead by a field goal right now. There's Walsh, not that big, 5'7", 168, a senior.
But he, like Briggs, has that great ability to stop and start and change directions. Amazing agility in some of these running backs.
Go defense!
At the 14 of New Mexico. Briggs to keep it. Up the field of the 10. He could be gone. Touchdown, Hawaii.
Briggs takes it in from 14 out, and the Rainbow Warriors lead it 30-21.
That's so frustrating because they make it look so easy when you... Now watch, he'll go against the green. He'll be coming to the bottom of your screen. He reads, he decides he wants to keep the ball. Now he'll go against the green. And it is so frustrating when they have that agility and are able to do that.
Nice little move there to finish off the touchdown run. Ron Valverde will attempt the extra point. Chris Gaskill's the holder for Hawaii, wide receiver. Kicks on the money. So the team set up the field with 3:54 to go in the third quarter, and your score now, the University of Hawaii 31, New Mexico 21. And here is Tracy Ratowski to kick it off. Following the Hawaii touchdown, here's Terrence Mathis, finds an opening, 30, and across the 35 to the 36-yard line. So the Lobos will have good field position, trailing it by 10 now. Take a look at the drive. Hawaii took the kickoff, started at their own 34. On a total of 66 yards, 8 plays, and of course Briggs on the quarterback keeper from 14 yards out. Only took them 3 minutes and 16 seconds to put together that Hawaii scoring drive, and it hurt the Lobos. So here's Garrison to start it up. It is, well, just outside his own 35, we'll call it. Fake the reverse. Tony Jones with a sweep. Good gainer. Across the 45 to midfield and out of bounds. They'll mark it just outside the 49 in Hawaii territory. First and 10 for New Mexico. William Bell rides him out of bounds. Gary, I think that's the longest run from scrimmage for the Lobos this year.
I was going to say it's all relative, but I think you're right. And the Lobos are continuing to go without the huddle now on offense.
Tony Jones and out of bounds just inside Rainbow territory. In the flat, Shane Hall with room across the 40 to the 39-yard line. Aaron Kane with a tackle for Hawaii. Another first and 10 for New Mexico as the track meet continues.
It appears as though both defenses wanted to stay in the locker room at this second half. You know, neither defense looks excited, and everything the offense wants to run is going for a first down every play.
Hawaii with a player down. Lobo football on KGSW TV is made possible in part by Coors Beer. Coors is the beer with a difference worth tasting.
You know, when there's an injury timeout and you're trying to take it as part of your strategy, you're trying to go without huddles in order to not permit substitutions or the defense to recover their breath. These injury timeouts really stop you, and that really foils that strategy. And I have to kind of wonder whether Hawaii doesn't have a designated injury timeout before when you go into the no-huddle offense.
What's more important, the coaching you'll do on the sidelines during a ball game or the coaching you do during the week to get ready for the ball game? Because obviously you have to make adjustments because a team comes in and they do different things than you expected.
Well, Jim, I can't say that one's more important. Both are important, and some coaches are better at one than another, or some coaching staffs are, I should say.
Garrison to Hall, and Hall breaks a tackle across the 30, and now they'll finally get him. The ball comes free, and Hawaii says they have it. They do. Hawaii has recovered. Brian Norwood comes up with a pigskin for Hawaii. Another costly turnover by New Mexico. Hawaii with a 10-point lead in the football.
And it is a costly turnover, but it's because Shane Hall does a great effort to try it. Now watch him evade this first tackle. Keeps his balance. Now, they're actually tackling the ball. It was stripped from him. Ball was clearly stripped from him.
Here we can see the fumble again. Well, we didn't catch the end of it. We're back to action. Briggs to go deep, has a man complete. That's Chris Roscoe all the way down to the Lobo 33. Gary, how did they get him that open?
Well, they loaded what they call a load situation. They had a wide out and a slot back to that side of the field and used a motion man to come back there, create a third receiver to the wide side of the field, and they all three run straight down the field. There were two defenders to cover them, so one's going to be free.
First and 10 at the Lobo 33. Hawaii leading it 31-21. Following a turnover, so many coaches like to go for the entire basket. And here's a reverse to Marco Johnson, who shows his great athletic ability before they finally get him out of bounds. Marcel Weiss finally to get him. Penalty marker is thrown. We had a tete-a-tete out there between Torrey Edwards and an offensive lineman in the area where it could be a clip. That'll be a break for the Lobos if it is.
And the Lobo defense are losing their cool a little bit there. They're very frustrated. Now watch Marco Johnson, yet another back with superb agility. Look at that. Jump out of tackles.
First down.
All right. Well, wishful thinking on my part, but it wouldn't alleviate the problem.
You know, when backs are that agile, you want to get the great hit on them, and the more frustrated you come, the more harder you want to go after them. But just the opposite is true. In order to tackle them, you have to be under more control.
So the penalty moves it to the Lobo 14, and Briggs, Hukava, not only took the football, but he took Briggs about a yard as well, and they get a short gainer on the play.
Hukava wanted the ball, I believe.
Looks like that big guy's down, Mark Nua, who weighs, 325 pounds, and he's 6'8".
When you get over 300 pounds, most scales of human weight stop at 300, so after 300, it might be a guess, or take them to the local truck stop or something, get them weighed. But
take them to the stockyard, right, because they have those big hangers where they...
But an interesting thing about Mark Nua, Mark Nua came to the University of Hawaii as a rugby player. He's from Auckland, New Zealand. He did not play American-style football, but he was an outstanding rugby player in Auckland, New Zealand.
I could see why. If I saw him coming, I'd issue the ball out of the scrimmage. There we go. Bacava says, Walter, you're going to have to get that to me a little quicker, or I'll carry you as well.
Well, there you see Nua, number 75. He was kind of leading that play, and you saw him roll over on his side. I don't know why.
Well, they're helping him up now.
He doesn't appear to be hurt too badly if he's going to go off the field on his own power.
If your company or business is interested in a tent rental for UNM's two remaining home games, November 7th against Wyoming or the 14th against Air Force, call Dick McKee at the UNM Athletic Department at 277-6375. It's a great opportunity for good friends to get together before a Lobo football game. And now we're back to the action. Second down at the 13 of New Mexico. Briggs rolls out, has room to the 10, to the 5, to the 4, and then driven out of bounds.
Key to this is if Clay Orson gets the outside linebacker gets pinned inside and he has to go inside the block to try to chase down Briggs, he's not going to be able to do it. And Walter Briggs is just too elusive.
225 yards total there. Al Nunga is in as a running back now, but he'll be there to block. Two finals in the WAC. Utah rallied to beat Colorado State 24-23, and the Air Force beat Navy 23-13 in Annapolis. Briggs to Fukava. He dives and has the first down. It'll be goal to go for the Hawaii Rainbow Warriors just inside the 3 of New Mexico. The whole third quarter has basically belonged to Hawaii thus far, although the Lobos did drive, but then they had the turnover.
And this is a place in the first half where the Lobo defensive front garnered their strength and stopped them cold, even a far heavier, stronger offensive line. But in this half, they're being moved.
Fukava bowls up to about the 1, and the Lobos stand him up and drop him. Good effort by the Lobos defensively that time. There's a guy you wanted everybody to watch on the special teams play, Gary, coming up with a big tackle.
Jeff McDonald, number 25. Now, Fukava tries to go over the top, and there you see Jeff McDonald, and I think he had help from Art Martinez.
Second and goal at the 2.
I can tell you, it's you take your life in your hands when you leap over the line of scrimmage as a ball carrier.
Well, they're not going to get anything on that.
Lobo's stacking it up in the middle pretty good. You get the indication the next one might be the fake dive and see that quarterback just head on into the end zone.
Well, I think I would. I think that'd be a good call because Briggs has such great speed and agility. Either that or I would come out and just run your triple option again and find some place along the line of scrimmage to just dive into the end zone.
The Lobos are taking a timeout. Excuse me, Gary. It appears the Lobos are taking a timeout or they have an injured player, and perhaps it's Marcel Weiss, I believe, who's sitting down. It is an injured player. There's Fakava, 16 carries, 76 yards, 2 TDs, and you were the one who said we'd see him a lot this afternoon.
Well, I think he's been kind of an overlooked back in the WAC conference. He's in the last 3 weeks, Fakava has established himself as a fine running back. He's got power. He's not all that fast, but he's got power, and he's also shifty, as all of the Hawaii backs appear to be.
Marcel Weiss is the injured player, and they're helping him off the field right now. Weiss is senior. In fact, the Lobos have 7 or 8 seniors, depending on what kind of a defense they're using, that start defensively.
And this play, this particular play, is worth a minimum of 4 points to the Lobos. It's so important they're using one of their timeouts.
So it'll be third and goal. We have a timeout on the field. Walter Briggs heading over to talk with his head coach, Bob Wagner. Hawaii leading it by 10, 31-21 with 8:33 to go in the third quarter. There have been fumbles and turnovers in the game, but the turnovers have hurt New Mexico more than the turnovers have hurt Hawaii thus far.
Yes, they have. And the reason I say this next play is worth 4 points. If the Lobos defense stops them here, it forces them to kick a field goal or attempt a field goal. And so that removes it from 7-3. But, of course, it may be worth more if they stop them on or if the field goal is either blocked or missed. So
there are the Lobo cheerleaders. Every weeknight on KGSW TV 14, you can join Rick and AJ and Simon. It's followed at 8 by great movie entertainment on the 8 o'clock movie. At 10, Tom Hanks stars in Bosom Buddies. And at 10:30, don't miss The Late Show. You can see it all weeknights here on KGSW TV 14. So following the timeout, Briggs comes up.
Hey, here,
he'll
Jim.
Call a timeout.
Hawaii wants a timeout now. It's going to be 10 minutes before this play is run.
How do you like those shirts those Hawaii coaches are wearing, huh?
Well, you can't mistake where they're from, can you?
The Aloha Spirit. Over there doing a baseball game at one time, the umpires wore shirts like that promoted a local watering hole, and they were all fined and suspended because, of course, that's not an umpire's uniform.
I was going to say, you've got to be kidding me. But
it was Kahlua's Lounge is where they got the shirt. And then, of course, they regretted it later. It wasn't worth the free shirt. But, yeah, you get that spirit over there. People loosen up. And an advantage that Hawaii has the rest of the season, if they can win this game, is they have 8 more games, but they are all at home. And 7 of the 8, if memory serves me correctly, no, 6 of the 8, are Western Athletic Conference games. Now, the reason that happens, there's Mike Shepard, the new head coach at UNM. The reason that happens is because the league has a deal. Hawaii plays you once at home and twice over there, and a lot of the coaches aren't in love with that idea.
Boy, I know if I were coaching in the WAC, I would not be in love with that idea either. Despite they use it to recruit, but it's not worth it.
Good job!
Here's Fakava diving in. He may be close, but he will not get it. It'll be fourth and goal, and my gut feeling is the Rainbow Warriors will go for it. Looks like they'll need about a foot.
And Jim, there is, to me, looking at this, I do not believe that the offensive formation was set a full second before that ball was snapped. They went on a quick count. And I can't believe there wasn't a flag thrown on that because they have to be set for one full second.
Lobos stop them. They're going to go for it.
There's Kirk Allen and Jeff McDonald again.
The charge, fourth and goal.
The charge of the man over the tackle is critical. He's got to go inside.
All right, Briggs has it. He's running around the backfield in trouble. Now pumps, heads, throws in the end zone, touchdown to Fakava. And I'll tell you, that was strictly athletic ability. The Lobos read the play. Briggs blew it for a moment, got outside. But with all the pursuit and all the confusion, Fakava snuck into the end zone, and the Island, or the Rainbow Warriors, get a big touchdown.
And I wonder if this wasn't done extemporaneously. I don't believe Fakava was supposed to be a receiver on that play. But he very wisely saw Briggs running for his life and then got into the end zone as the receiver.
37-21. Hawaii leading it, and here is Val Verde to attempt the extra point. That's a big touchdown for Hawaii, and they get it on a broken ad-lib play. The kick is good. 7:39 to go in the third quarter. Hawaii opening things up. They lead New Mexico 38-21. Stay with us. We'll be right back with you. All right, here we go. The kickoff hit deep. Terrence Mathis will take it. 38-21, Hawaii leads it. Mathis finds a gap. There he goes. To midfield. Breaks a tackle. To the 30. To the 20 and out of bounds at the 13 of Hawaii. And it's a shot in the arm the Lobos needed. Gavin Robertson prevented what could have been a return, I believe, that would have gone for 95 yards. Penalty marker down, Gary. I guess they got his face masked top of everything else.
I think Gavin Roberts did reach for anything he could and got a face mask, and he kind of bulldogged him to the ground. But now watch. They've been trying consistently to break the wedge to their sideline in front of their bench, and there it is. He is untouched. Now he makes a beautiful cut there. Beautiful cut.
First down.
The cut cost him the angle, however, and allowed Roberts to get the angle to get him.
Mike Henderson wanted to check in the game for New Mexico, but there was no room at the end, so he'll head back to the sideline. Lobos first and goal, or check that, first and five at the 7 of Hawaii. Here's Reggie Rogers to sweep it with room, and touchdown New Mexico. So the Lobos, after the big return, strike pay dirt, and it's 38-27. New Mexico climbs right back in the football game.
Well, it's the type of thing that brings you back. Once again, I don't think either defense wanted to play this half. Everybody's just doing it. Both offenses are moving virtually at will. That's just a simple sweep play, but it's well executed by the Lobo offense. Terrence Donaldson, number 65, out in front.
Walsh will kick the extra point. Gets it good. Kicks good. 7:23 to go in the third quarter. Your score now, Hawaii 38, the Lobos 28. Things continue to be extremely interesting. Stay right with us. Ease it up. Terrence Mathis with a return started at his own 7. Lobos strike on the very next play after Mathis is dropped outside the 10. The Lobos get 5 more on a face mask. So the Lobos are right back in it. Oh, there's the kick, and Albrecht not only kicks it out of the end zone, he kicks it way out of the end zone with the wind at his back. So the football comes out to the 20. It'll be first down and 10 for Hawaii. The Rainbow Warriors by 10 in a very high-powered offensive football game.
Well, you have to root for the defenses here because neither one of them showed up yet this half. The Lobo drive, of course, the big part of that was the return of the kickoff by Terrence Mathis. And Jim, Terrence has to regain his lead, national lead, in all-purpose yardage this week, don't you think?
Without a doubt. Briggs at the throttle, the southpaw to throw. Fires downfield. I believe the receiver went out of bounds and came back inbounds. You cannot do that.
You can't do it. You can't leave but on your own accord and come back in. You can be forced out and come back in. But I agree with you. I don't think that Troy Clewis, the corner on that side, had forced him out.
As a high school coach, you had a play, Gary, where he'd swing a receiver to the sideline, and they'd be standing close to the sideline. Receiver would melt into the players. Another guy would pop out and catch the football, and it worked many times. The officials would not catch it. Fumble. Lobos have it. So New Mexico takes over at the 20 of Hawaii. Billy Stevens lost it. I believe Torrey Edwards or Kirk Allen, one of the two, had the football. I believe it was Torrey Edwards. We'll take a look again and see just who got the pigskin.
How about Orlando Lavelle?
All right.
Let's see who gets this. It's just awfully difficult to see. It wasn't Lavelle, though. I think Lavelle is still left on the picture.
So the Lobos, who a minute and 39 seconds ago were behind 38-21, trail 38-28, and have the football at the Rainbow Warrior 20-yard line. Here's Barry Garrison.
Go, Lobos! Come on,
loose. Now Hawaii after it, and Garrison retrieves at the 34-yard line. Al Nunga broke up that play.
There was Nunga at his best, and I guarantee you the 17 NFL scouts like this, like what they see here. Holy cow.
Bobby Edwards recovered the fumble for New Mexico.
Okay, well, we none of us had him pegged, did we?
We had Torrey in there, not Bobby.
Well, this makes it awfully difficult here. Now, what you don't want to do is get impatient. Just stay patient. You've got three downs to get it. You're in four down territory. Get 7 or 8 yards of credit.
Second and a long 23 for Garrison at the Hawaii 34. He's got all the time in the world. Fires complete to Duff. Duff fumbles the football, and Hawaii has it. Oh, the Rainbow Warriors' William Bell was right there. Has the football. The Lobos turned away on a costly turnover. The second time in a football game that New Mexico has gotten the ball from Hawaii on a turnover deep in Rainbow Warrior territory and then has turned around, not scored, or turned it back over.
Oh, and this play is so frustrating. John Duff has it, and he cannot cradle that football, and there it goes free.
He and Walter Briggs would be something on the same football team. Briggs wants to keep it. Pitches. Lewis Lede is hammered and dropped. Can't close any better on the play than Danny Lara did for New Mexico that time.
And for the first time, the Lobo defense played the triple option inside out, 1-2-3, like you want to play it, and there was no place to go.
Hawaii player down, Theo Adams, the big right tackle, is on the turf right now.
All right, let's see how they stop this 1-2-3. Now, let's see who stops. Orlando Lavelle stops the dive man. Kirk Allen's on the quarterback. He had been getting cut off and not been able to get there, and Danny Lara was on the pitch man. 1-2-3. So, what you got to play?
Number of players down and injured. Theo Adams is down right now.
I was just going to comment on that. A number of players down. Now they'll get up and they'll come off the field on their own power, but in the meantime, the clock stops. Play stops.
6:08 to go, third quarter, Gary. You were saying you have to wonder.
Well, you have to wonder. See, here he'll come off the field. Now, they're not charged timeout if he comes off the field.
Could be a ploy by Hawaii, perhaps, to rest up. They're playing at a mile high. They come from sea level, but I don't know how much of a fan I am of that theory.
Well,
if you can play, you can play anywhere.
I'm not a fan at all of that theory, but it's happening so frequently, it makes you wonder if that's not part of the strategy.
This time they try the left side to get about five with Fakava, but penalty markers are thrown.
Counter dive, and it was the trap play.
Holding on Hawaii. Theo Adams hurt his neck, obviously, as he applied some ice to his neck. When I was in school, sometimes they told me I should apply that ice
Holding.
To my brain.
Offense, second down.
Warren Jones is quarterbacking now for Hawaii in the never-ending turnstile quarterbacking.
I'll leave your comment alone. Warren Jones, here's the passer now. They're in a passing situation.
Second, and we'll call it 20. Hawaii at their own 17. Well, that little shuttle pass, it'll get them a little bit. Look at this Marco Johnson, huh? Does he have some moves? He's out to the 33, and they'll have third down and short now, as Johnson showed why many people call him, like Al Nunga, an All-American candidate.
And I think the pros who are here to see El Nanga are getting their fill of Marco Johnson. He's going to go on a lot of their pads, their scratch pads and notes.
Third down, 3 yards to go for Hawaii. At their own 33, they lead it 38-28. Third quarter of play. Play action fake. Jones is in trouble. He's sacked. He fumbles but gets it back.
John Bell split the guard in the center. Did an excellent job of getting in there on Jones. Now watch as they line up. There you see John Bell. Hey, hometown fans and freshmen doing a great job. And have they needed him this year as thin as they have been on the... Oh, and we get another guy down. Lying down here, another Hawaii player going to lie down. Now, he'll get up and walk off the field on his own. We'll see.
Warren Jones is the player down. 4 minutes, 47 seconds remaining in the third quarter of play. Hawaii leading it 38-28. They led 24-21 at the half and came out with both barrels loaded. They scored two touchdowns to go ahead 38-21. Then Mathis with a big return, and the Lobos countered with a score. And here it is again with Jones.
And John Bell, noticing on his replay, had tackled the dive man first, and then he recovers on the quarterback. Well, now it does look that, like, Jones' leg, he did get bent over backwards. But now he got up after the play and was walking around, and then he sat down. Call timeout. If you can do that, you can trot off the field and not stop the clock.
We're going to take a break. Everyone else is. 4:47 to go, third quarter. 38-28 the score. Kick that again. We'll get a good roll and go out of bounds at the Lobo 38. So New Mexico starts there. 4:33 to go in the third quarter with Hawaii leading it 38-28. Still early in the football game, but the Lobos would like to post some points right here. The punt went for 35 yards.
And the reason I think he didn't get a good foot in that, he was in too big a hurry. He saw the rush coming, especially in the number 29, Randy Johnson, bearing down on him. Shane Hall and Tony Jones return to the backfield instead of Reggie Johnson and Scott Howard.
Here's Garrison. First and 10, audible Ising at the line of scrimmage. Shane Hall with room. Hit. Ball comes free, but Hall managed to gather it back in. Very close to a first and 10. William Bell came in with the crushing tackle, and he stood Shane up hard that time.
And the previous carry of Shane's was a nice pass reception, a nice run off of a screen pass in which he fumbled. And here he gets hit right in the midsection. He run a little bit too high, Shane. Cover that ball, partner.
Watching the line play, looks like we got some personal wars developing. Like they don't care about the ball carrier. They just want to mix it up with each other. Here's Garrison firing deep downfield for Al Owens. Incomplete. Al had it and lost it.
He
staring up into the sun with Saunders on the coverage.
That was it. He lost it in the sun. That ball ended up perfectly thrown. Perfectly thrown, but he had to look right back into the sun, and the defender had crossed right in front of him. He just come out from beyond the defender and lost it in the sun.
Garrison's got an excellent arm. They talk about some of the quarterbacks around the country. He can fire it downfield with anybody. Garrison now on a bootleg under pressure fires to Duff, who bobbles and loses it incomplete. It'll be third and 10 for the Lobos at their own 49. Remember, they trail it 38-28. Pat McCray came up and hit Duff. He bobbled it, then McCray hit him, and then John couldn't get it back.
But what McCray did for the Hawaii defense was to force Garrison to release the ball far before he wanted to. He wanted Duff to get a chance to get further downfield. But McCray contained him and forced him to run only backwards and to cough up the football.
Garrison, third and 10. High backs behind Garrison. Play action fake. Barry downfield, that's Shane Hall. He'll be short of the first down. Hawaii closed in well on that play. It was a good safe call, but it'll bring up fourth down.
Well,
Lane Santiago was the guy who finally brought Shane Hall down, but Albrecht has to punt.
And they're not quite in what you would consider four-down territory. In other words, they're going to try to keep the ball downfield, use and short punt it here, use their field position advantage. Watch Troy Clewis.
He couldn't get it. The fans upset because Troy was screened out by a Hawaii player, but unless I'm mistaken, Kim McLeod out there, and there's no rule that says he can't screen him away from
the
ball.
And it was in the end zone, too. Once it crosses the end zone, why it's brought out as a touchback anyway. Let's watch this here. He's in the end zone, you see.
Troy knows what it's like as a defensive back now to be a wide receiver. That's the way they shadow you. So the Rainbow Warriors at their own 20, leading at 38-28. Briggs buried for a loss at the 15. John Bell making his presence felt in the second half of play.
Yes, indeed. Chasing him from behind. Shows some quickness. This guy, number four, can run, as we've seen all through the first half. Look at number 99 bearing down from behind, extending himself, reaching out. Nice job by the freshman from Albuquerque. Del Norte High School, coached by David Williams.
Second down, 14 for Hawaii. Briggs stays into quarterback. Jones was injured in the last series. Briggs goes wide, breaks a tackle, goes out of bounds at the 20-yard line. It'll be third and 10. 2:43 to go in the third quarter of play.
Briggs got a lot of help by Fakava, who cut off Kirk Allen from pursuing. Now, Kirk Allen eventually forced him out of bounds for no gain, but had Fakava not detained Allen, he would have been sacked for a loss.
Lede, or rather Johnson, in motion to the bottom of your screen. Briggs, a quarterback draw. He's dangerous, and he will have a first down. That one looked like it was designed all the way to be your old quarterback drop, and it worked. Art Martinez made the tackle.
You're
a little
right.
Player down, apparently. No, they're just having a hard time on stacking.
Now, you know, as agile as Briggs is, oh, look at the way he catches that. Well, you're right. Briggs is going to fumble it again sooner or later.
I would just say, hey, if somebody else is tackling him, go in there and take it from him, because he's waving it at everybody. Easier said than done, though.
Yeah.
That's MacArthur in motion this time. Not General MacArthur. Fakava up the middle. Gets about six that time. Dane MacArthur, 28 in motion that time. Just a freshman. Hawaii, they don't play that many freshmen. They have a lot of seniors on defense themselves, but have been very tough defensively because of their experience. Six in the country, first in the WAC, but the Lobos have scored 28 points on them. Second and a long two. Here's that snap again, and everybody jitterbugging at the line of scrimmage. We'll see who it goes against this time.
Well, the Lobo defensive front responded against the backfield shift. Now remember, a back can run, one back can be in motion, parallel or away from
defense. First down.
The line of scrimmage, and they can also shift their positions on the field as long as they get set then for 1 second before the snap.
Bacava, 18 carries and has picked up 83 yards. Two touchdowns to his credit. First and 10 Hawaii following the penalty inside their own 43, leading it by 10. Briggs goes to Fakava. Look at him break out. He could be gone to the 30, 20, 10. They catch him. Saving tackle drops Hikoti Fakava at the one-yard line. Fakava has rushed for over 100 yards now, at 211 last week, a 57-yard carry, and Hawaii looking to score a key touchdown now.
And you have to wonder, how agile are these running backs? Well, in fact, the great ball handling lost our cameraman too, but he just faked out the safeties. And there you see Danny Lara catch him, running him down from behind. But my golly, those Hawaii running backs, they all seem to leave tacklers diving at the ground.
Al Nungo will lead the way. He's in at the fullback. Here we go with Fakava. The Lobos do that about as well as anybody I've seen this season. Stack it up on short yardage situations inside the 3-yard line. But as Gary alluded to, if someone was to fake that play and pitch the ball or carry it outside, there is absolutely no one out there.
And you have to wonder what somebody like the big guy, Nanga, leading the play, why they can't punch it in against a relatively small defensive front that the Lobos have. It's just guts on the part of those defenders on the line of scrimmage.
Second and goal. There go wide this time. Fakava fumbles into the end zone. The Lobos get it. What a turnaround for New Mexico.
Jeff McDonald.
McDonald gets the fumble. Well, they went wide, as we said they would, but they turned it over. What a break for New Mexico.
And there again, there it is from the right on the goal line. Fakava looks tired. Well, look he lost.
I've got him on a leg.
Oh, there that is. You think that ball doesn't attract a crowd?
36 seconds to go, third quarter. Boy, it looked like Hawaii was on the verge of making it very tough for the Lobos to come back. And they fumble into the end zone, and the Lobos bring it out to their own 20. Three fumbles now by Hawaii this afternoon. Garrison to throw, complete to Mathis, spins away from one tackler. He's down at the 38. A gain of 18 yards, first and 10, New Mexico. Eric Lalo made the tackle.
And you know, this is a bad sun field situation for the Lobo defenders. They have to look back into the sun. And right now, they have the wind at their back as the third quarter winds down the last 22 seconds. But the receivers will be happy to get away from having to look into the sun. That was a great job by Terrence Mathis.
At the 38, first and 10, New Mexico. Garrison, two wide receivers to the bottom of your screen. He's back to pass. With time, dumps it over to John Duff. Duff breaks a tackle, heads upfield. He's got a first down at the 49 of New Mexico. A gain of 11. Joaquin Barnett made the stop for Hawaii. So the Lobo is following the turnover. Are moving the football, and the third quarter has come to a conclusion.
I wonder if the defenses will come on the field in the fourth quarter. No defense has stopped their opponents yet this half.
They've stopped themselves here. There's Duff. As the teams switch ends of the field, pause, 38-28 Hawaii after three. Play, Hawaii leads it, the Lobos are moving it. Reggie Rogers, however, heads the wrong direction and is buried back at the 46 of New Mexico for a loss of 3 yards. It'll be second and 13. 38-28, Hawaii by 10.
This is a sweep play. Watch the guards pulling. 66 Guy Kalura there. He was to cut off tackle, but he didn't. He decided to give a little ground to go outside for the big gain and lost about 3 extra yards. Kind of a wrong decision there, Reggie.
So Garrison, probably in a spot he likes, second and 13. He's had a big afternoon. Garrison back to throw. Under pressure. Fires incomplete. Shane Hall was the man he wanted. Around the 45-yard line, but there really wasn't much there. Good coverage that time by the Hawaii secondary.
Well, that's what you call flooding a zone, and you have a short receiver and a wide receiver to that side of the field, plus somebody, a tight end to hold them, the safety in the middle. But what Barry has to do is if he's going to throw in the flat, he must throw it sooner than when he did.
Now working without a tight end as Garrison drops on third and 13, fires, Hall has it, breaks a tackle, he has a first down just outside the 40 of Hawaii. Boy, Shane Hall with just some excellent second effort all the way.
You know, last year on that same sideline in front of the Lobos bench in a drive against Tulsa. Shane Hall made an even more difficult catch. This ball is laid in there pretty well, but it's a big third down play, and he eludes a tackler or two there and has to go to get the first. But in that same situation last year in that drive against Tulsa, Shane made one of the most beautiful catches I've ever seen.
At the 40-yard line, first and 10 New Mexico, and Garrison will have to waste a timeout. Now, the Lobos are down 38-28, and each time you use a timeout, that means that you are only going to have one less as the game progresses. And now you take a look at New Mexico, they have only one timeout left. And we'll be right back. 13:42 to go in the game. Lobos driving, they trail by 10. Following their timeout just inside the Hawaii 40-yard line. Al Owens in motion. Garrison in trouble. They've got him. He's sacked back at his own 48. That'll be a loss of 12. Second and 22 will be the situation the Lobos will face.
Big loss situation. Whatever that timeout was for, it didn't help them any because they wanted to throw the ball downfield. They wanted to go for a touchdown on that play, but without the time to throw it. Got to have a receiver in the flats. You have to have somebody to dump the ball to.
So Garrison now back to throw. In trouble. Hit incomplete. Barry did a good job to get rid of that ball. Sam Carroll along with Al Nunga were closing in.
Barry looks like he took a pretty hard hit. He got up very slowly there. Let's see if it's Nunga or Carroll that gets him. It's from the blind side, which that's what quarterbacks do not like.
The Lobos have yet another week off next week before they go to play Colorado State. Then it's on to Utah. Then back home for a couple, then on the road for San Diego State and Arkansas to end the season. Hall the lone running back, Garrison to throw it. Downfield for Duff, incomplete. Good defensive play that time for Hawaii. Closing in with an excellently timed hit was Brian Norwood, but some of the Lobo faithful felt like he was there early. Looked to me, Gary, like he played it perfectly.
Well, let's take a look at this. Down the middle, Mathis and Owens are receiving the double coverage. The man to throw to would be your tight end. Let's see how this is timed. I'm not sure.
It's close. Here's the punt by Albrecht, and he hammers it towards the end zone, which I don't understand, and that'll move Hawaii out to the 20, a flag down on the play. And he took a look at the replay. It looked like he might have gotten there before the football. When at first I saw it, it looked like he timed it pretty well, but it was a very close put. 38-28, Hawaii leading it. The penalty goes against the Lobos. We'll wait and see what Hawaii decides to do. Could just take the football at their own 20. What would be the logic in forcing them to punt again?
It kind of depends on how far you think your opponent can punt it. Albrecht easily made it to the end zone, so I think they would just take it there.
52-yard punt, but they net only 32 because he kicked it into the end zone. Okay, at the quarterback slot, it'll be Walter Briggs. Hawaii leading at 38-28, 12:44 to go in the game. And Briggs on that quarterback keeper, and he doesn't get but a yard. Kirk Allen read it perfectly, second and 9 for Hawaii.
You know, Kirk Allen has the toughest job on the field. He has to read the quarterback. He has to stop he has to make sure that the dive plays, that the dive is stopped. Then he has to get out on the quarterback. And the quarterback oftentimes starts one direction, comebacks the other.
There is Billy Stevens with a big hole, and he's got a first down out to the 31-yard line. Of course, this is a day game, and you're seeing it tape delayed starting at 10. Gary, we've had some fans ask us, well, if it's a day game, why can't you run it perhaps at 7? But the WAC, unlike perhaps the Pac-10, has a rule
that your replay cannot begin until 10 in the evening.
Until 10, and this one's taking an awful long time to run. No telling how late it will be tonight before you can see this point of the game.
You saw Stevens' graphic there. He's had a good afternoon. Briggs rolling left, shows pass, and then goes out of bounds after a small gain. Be second and long for Hawaii. Clay Orison driving Briggs out of bounds. I was talking with John Koenig about that rule, and of course the Pac-10 will let you start it right after the game. And he said he was going to speak to the commissioner and discuss some of those things. Perhaps they can be changed.
Yeah. I think KGSW's viewers would approve of it being moved up a little bit.
Well, when you have a night game, it's perfect, but when you play in the afternoon, not necessarily the fact. Of course, as long as this game is, it may be 10 when we get home. Here's Coldine Wallstry in the middle, and he'll get just inside the 35. It'll be third down. We'll call it 6 for Hawaii.
And John Bell, who I think is having an outstanding game, he was the first man to get to Walsh. He forced Walsh back up into the middle.
Got a player down, this time a Lobo player.
Musa Kaniki in that ever-thinning defensive line crew. Coach Michael White will hate to see losing another lineman. Now, actually, there's Kaniki 79. He had to plant and come back. He landed funny on the leg. He's being helped off the field. But the Lobos cannot afford to lose another defensive lineman.
Going into the fourth quarter, Gary, this is of interest. Hawaii had rushed for 396 yards, and the Lobos had rushed for 24. Lobos had passed for 342, and Hawaii had passed for 114. That's quite a bit of yardage on the ground, 396 going into the fourth stanza.
That really is. That's the type of yardage figures that the Air Force Academy gets running that wishbone when they've really run up the score against somebody.
They went to 5-1 today. Here's Briggs on a little counter. He will not get the first down. Lobos stack him up well. But they really had to hustle at Annapolis. Navy gave them all they wanted. They won finally 23-13, but it was tied 13-13 at one time. Navy not that good this year, but when they play one of the other academies, they rally. And so Air Force, after that sluggish start when they lost their opener, Gary, have probably been the most impressive team in the WAC. There's Briggs, 27 carries, 151 yards, and a TD. Air Force comes in here on the 14th of November. Randy Johnson, here's a loose punt. Johnson going after it. Gets it at his own 26. And is dropped at the 29, and then ridden back of the 26. Leon Austin on the special teams play for Hawaii, leading the way on the tackle.
All right. Lobos get decent field position. And the clock is not yet a factor.
10:42 to go. Plenty of time remaining.
10-man lineup there on the line.
Went after it and didn't get it.
Now, it's awfully lonesome for number 29 because there's no one up there protecting him. They're all trying to block the punt.
Garrison, a little running play. Now they reverse it to Al Owens. They're closing in on Owens, and he's dropped for a loss back at the 21. Pat McRae read it like he was in the Lobo huddle to figure it out in the first play.
He was waiting on it, and he wanted, and Terrence Mathis was out there to block for him, but he could not block McRae from behind. And actually, it's good that he did not, because had he attempted to do so, it would have been a clip, and they would have added 15 more yards onto that loss.
The reason I brought up Air Force, Gary, is how do they do it year in and year out?
I don't think I've got an explanation for it, and that is I don't think college defenses work enough against the wishbone.
Okay. Here's Hall on a little draw, breaks one tackle, and gets about three out to the 23. Well, that explains the way their offense works, but their defense isn't that bad either.
Well, they've got a player by the name of Chad Hennings, and when he comes here, he's probably the closest person to a Nanga that we'll see this year. And Chad Hennings is what they call the unblockable man. He has just dominated the line of scrimmage. He will be something to watch when he comes here. That's what they've got going for him on defense.
Garrison, third down at his own 23. 16 yards is what he needs. Garrison scrambling towards the near sideline. Fires upfield to Mathis. What a catch, complete. At the 44-yard line, first and 10 New Mexico. You can't catch a football any better than that. Mathis looks to be shaken up.
I believe it's only perhaps getting the wind knocked out of him, either when he got hit or when he hit the ground. Now, a nice bit of scrambling here from Garrison. Had to go high for it. Had to go high for it. Mathis left the field under his own power. Let's look at this up down there. Down closer to field level. You see how high in the air he was. Nothing wrong, nothing illegal about that hit.
Six catches, 139 yards from Mathis. Owens in motion to the top of your screen. Tony Jones with room. Midfield, he could be gone. 40, spins from another tackler to the 34. Eric Lalo dropped him. One Rainbow Warrior just got a hand on him, or he might have been gone for the touchdown.
Oh, Jim, it is so good to see the Lobos gaining yardage on the ground. That was a nice run by Tony Jones. But Guy Kalura, 66, watch him. And Terrence Donaldson, 65, get out in front. There's Kalura out in front, see? Nice bit of running there. That does so much for your... Oh, cleaning up block there by Kalura. Does so much to raise the spirits of your offensive line.
At the 34 of Hawaii, Lobos trail it 38-28. 8.5 minutes to go. Here's Reggie Rogers again. And Rogers to the 21-yard line. Another first and 10 for New Mexico. Brian Norwood had the saving tackle that time.
Art Valero's hollering his guys, open up that hole. They're the same two guards, and there's Shane Hall out in front. Ed Lambert's coaching of his running backs. Shane Hall's an excellent blocker. Hard to coach running backs to block. They want to run with it or catch with it, but I'll tell you, Shane Hall and Tony Jones block for each other as well as they can.
Garrison, first and 10 at the Hawaii 21. Looks like Barry's audibilizing. Hall tries the middle, and he'll get about four to the 17-yard line of Hawaii. He's second and six. Just under 8 minutes to go. Hawaii leading it by 10.
You know, you will notice a much slower rush now that you break those running plays against a defensive front. That nothing slows down the rush like having to watch for the ball come by you.
Garrison at the 17 to throw it with time. Now jitterbugs around. They don't have him. Now heads towards the sideline. Fires to Hall. Incomplete. Well, that was quite a piece of disco dancing by Barry Garrison. He eluded not one, not two, but three and perhaps four tacklers before he finally dumped it off.
All right, I know this is after the fact, but here's where he should dump the ball to Hall is open here. But now he's trying to go down further downfield with all of this. Now Hall is shadowing him towards the end line to try to get open, and Barry sees him, but by then it's too late.
Third and five at the Rainbow Warriors 17. Owens headed to the bottom of your screen in motion. Barry Garrison back to throw. Fires complete to Shane Hall. First and goal at the 8-yard line for New Mexico. They trail it 38-28.
There once again is that very important short pass reception by Shane Hall. This is what you call a circle pattern. The linebackers are coming. He's running into the space vacated by a linebacker who is rushing. Now Barry Garrison has to recognize that, and you got to give Barry credit for that too. Well executed.
First and goal at the 8. They're going to run it with Tony Jones. This time Tony stacked up. Might have got to the 7-yard line. That'll be it on that play. Second and goal for the Lobos. Time is important. 6:52 and counting remaining in the football game. Hawaii came out, got a couple of quick touchdowns in the third quarter. Then in the waning moments of the third quarter, had what looked to be an opportunity to put the game away. But from the two, Fakava fumbled into the end zone, and now the Lobos are charging back.
I believe they're going to have to throw it here. I think we're going to have to see a rollout pass here, maybe a bootleg type action.
Second and goal, play action fake. Garrison being pursued, and he gets away. Now Barry fires it, incomplete. Now Hawaii saying Garrison was out of bounds when he passed the football, and now the one official runs over and says, you're right. So that's another example of where we've seen in the WAC many times where a coach officiates the ball game.
Now the difference here is that McCray, once again, does not let the Barry get outside on the bootleg. He does not let him get outside. Now, Barry eventually does just because he steps out of a tackle.
Now, you'll see no official come over and say he's out of bounds until the Hawaii coaches run up and say he was out of bounds.
And here's the, I believe this is fourth down situation, is it not?
Third down, Gary. Goal to go, but from the 17, and now Hawaii will waste a timeout. Third and goal at the 18. A field goal is not that bad. Still plenty of time. 6 minutes, 17 seconds to go. Down by 10. And, of course, if you drive down, score the touchdown, you can go for two and win the football game.
All right, let's see this scramble from another angle. This is from somewhat our perspective here. We cannot see the sideline, but you can tell he's getting awfully close.
If your company or business is interested in a 10-minute...
That's the Submariner shot there.
Please contact Dick McKee at the UNM Athletic Department.
I think it's very fortunate that Hawaii's defense called the timeout. This is a very strategic play here. Third down, this would be a time for your reverse or your shuffle pass. I'd like to see that shuffle pass play. Then Hawaii's used it once against the Lobos very effectively in a third down situation.
There's Terrence Mathis. Terrence, of course, injured the left arm but was only out for two plays. Six receptions, 139 yards, one touchdown, five returns of kicks for 152 yards. Now that's a total of 292 yards. Hey, that was pretty good, huh?
All right.
291? Oh, boy, missed it by a yard. All right, plunk him, send him back. All righty, here's Garrison to throw. Third and goal at the 18. He's in trouble now, and he just fires it out of bounds, and that'll bring on the field goal team. Rick Walsh, the sidewinder, has missed one attempt from 37 yards out this afternoon. He'll kick this one into a pretty strong breeze. It'll be on the hash mark to the bottom of your screen, which is the hash mark where, Gary, you say they like to kick them because a sidewinder naturally hooks kicks.
But the one that he missed, he did not have any hook on it at all. In fact, he did not meet it well at all. So he's just got to worry about making good contact with the ball. The hook will come naturally.
33-yard attempt from our vantage point. Garrison to hold. Here's the kick. Good. Just got inside the left upright. So the Lobos get a big field goal off the bare foot of Rick Walsh. 6:11 to go. Hawaii 38, the Lobos 31. Stay right with us. Lobo rally. They're down by a touchdown. 6:11 to go. Marcel Williams brings the kickoff up the field and gets out to the 35 of Hawaii before the Lobos drop him. Albrecht had to kick into a stiff wind, and that held the kick up. And unfortunately, Williams was able to get a very decent return, and the Rainbow Warriors have good field position. They lead 38-31.
All right, your defense is rested. Now you got to play, and if you're Hawaii, you think on the ground, they've got their basic running quarterback in there, Briggs. Play the triple option, inside out, 1-2-3.
Briggs now will keep it, but only gets a yard to the 35. Maybe less than a yard. It'll be second and a long nine. Torrey Edwards with a stop. Some finals in the WAC. Air Force beat Navy 23-13. Utah rallied to beat Colorado State 24-23. And Wyoming beat BYU 22-14. We'll have a couple of other finals for you involving ranked teams after this second down play. BYU 3-3. That's too bad. Here's Briggs. Little keeper to the 35. It'll be third down and long. Games involving ranked teams. Washington upset Arizona State 27-14. Alabama was upset by Memphis State 13-10. Michigan State beat Michigan. And Indiana walloped Ohio State, nationally ranked 31-10. Gary, it's just parity and balance all over the country. In fact, many good teams will lose three or four games this year.
Let's hope we see one more upset. The Lobos, 38-39. Hawaii, 38.
They'll run it with Fukava. And he's stacked up. It'll be fourth and long, and Hawaii will have to punt. The Lobos have a world of time. 4:43 remaining in the football game.
The defense did exactly what they were supposed to do. Hawaii comes out there, runs three triple options, never get beyond number two of their triple option, and the Lobos defended it well.
Randy Johnson will return the punt for the Lobos. Kyle Alou is the punter, barefoot punter, left foot punter. You can't get any more unique than that. Here's the punt. Boy, he hits this one well. Johnson back, lets it go. Get in that end zone, and it does. Lobos will bring it out to the 20. I guess the next thing we'll see, Gary, is we've got all these barefoot punters and kickers, is the guy will come out with both feet bare.
I don't know why.
And be an ambidextrous. 65-yard punt, 45 net, penalty marker thrown.
He'll play in the southern latitudes, that's for sure. Conference going on in the middle of the field for a flag down. Let's see what happens here.
4:07 to go. Plenty of time. Gary, now offensively, the Lobos down 38-31. They don't want to fool around, but they don't want to rush themselves.
No, they don't. Let's see what... let's see if this happened before the punt, which grants them a first, granted Hawaii first down.
Well, let's hope it's not another too many men on the field situation or a...
No, he did say illegal participation was the...
That's the second time that's happened to New Mexico this year in a clutch
illegal
situation.
Illegal participation on the defense. We'll have a first down.
That happened at New Mexico State, Gary, and that's an automatic first down.
And both times they have occurred in very critical situations. All right, can't change that. Defense has to do exactly what it did previously. Now let's see if Hawaii opens this up and tries to sprint out or tries to throw. Defense better get on the field here.
The ball's at midfield now. 12 men on the field. It happened at New Mexico State. It happens here. And Hawaii has the football back and can churn up some more time. Here's the keeper by Briggs with room to the 40. He could break it. 30, 25, 20, 15, down inside the 10 at the Lobo 9-yard line. Brett Heber made the touchdown-saving tackle. Oh, the turnovers and the mental mistakes will kill you.
And whose responsibility is the quarterback? You see Clay Orison tackle a fullback. A pulling guard turned in Kirk Allen. Danny Lara is waiting outside.
For the
pitch man.
41-yard run for Briggs. He has amassed 191 yards rushing, and the Rainbow Warriors have to be over 500 yards rushing as a team.
Can you ask the defense one more goal line stand?
3:45 to go. There's Fukava in for the touchdown, but penalty markers everywhere. More hankies than you'll see at a wedding, and they'll send it back and talk it over.
I believe it was the same thing they had done earlier. They don't get down for a snap. When they get in the goal line offense situation, they like to go from a quick count.
Dead ball. False start. Offense. First down. It was there.
Well, that moves Hawaii back. 3:42 to go.
That helps.
38-31, Hawaii. Excuse me, Gary.
That helps the goal line defense situation, but now you got to play the clock, too. What Hawaii's going to do is keep this on the ground.
Come on,
You can see the time ticking away. Here's Fakava. They might be content to just go ahead and play for the field goal here. Val Verde, their field goal kicker, is very consistent. He's been around for a number of years. You've seen him kick.
And he's got the wind at his back, and they've positioned the ball in the center of the field, although they still have a couple of downs left. They are in four-down territory should they want to use all four downs to get the first and keep the drive alive.
And, of course, they're milking that clock. And the Lobos are going to use a timeout, and that is their last timeout in the football game. So should they get the football back, they'll have to drive down to score to perhaps win it. They'll have to do that without use of a timeout. The early timeouts used so many times come back to haunt you. 38-31. Timeout on the field.
Three
Gary,
timeout.
Defensively now, what are the Lobos talking about? And offensively, when you're done with that, what's Hawaii going to be discussing here?
Well, defensively first, I think you got to give the situation. I would say look for the counter option, maybe even the option reverse in this situation. If they get in a third and long, they're still in a second down situation. But they're pretty well going to run the ball. You got to make sure you know who has containment responsibilities and make good tackles, make sure tackles. Offensively, if I were Hawaii, on the other hand, I would say you've got to throw the ball to get in the end zone. But as you say, if they're content to just keep it in the middle, use up the clock, and then kick the field goal on fourth down, that's, you know, they've got two choices. Hawaii has more choices than the Lobos do right now.
My total on Briggs was incorrect. It's not 191, it's 292 yards total rushing, as the graphic indicated. That is something else, Gary.
That really is.
Of course, Fakava had 211 last week against Yale. The Yaleys went to Hawaii and took the night off. Got beat 62-10, but had a good time. Here's Briggs, little quarterback draw. And they're content to line up the field goal, one would think, and milk the clock, 2:56 and counting remaining.
Yeah, that's apparent. That was what they decided to do, was go for the field goal. All right, here's your chance. The Lobos have to block this. They go up 41. It's going to put it. That means the Lobos are going to have to score twice.
Well, it is third down, and some coaches would kick here, you know, thinking, well, perhaps we might lose it or something could happen, but they're going to go ahead and run one more play, and we'll look for Briggs, maybe just a quarterback sneak, or who knows? You never know. They might be trying to buffalo him, but here's Briggs on the keeper, and he kind of played it very conservatively, and rather Fakava did have it.
Yeah.
So he got it in a little closer outside the 10.
He stayed right in the middle of the field. I don't think that they needed the yardage so much as they wanted to use that extra down and use the clock.
2:05 and counting. Remember, there is no two-minute warning in college football, so that won't help the Lobos. Now here's a guy that could pretty much can the ball game, Rod Valverde.
And you have to attempt to block this. You have to block it.
Troy, it'll be a 28-yard attempt unofficially.
Watch Troy Cluis.
There she goes. He hit it well. It's good. 1:44 to go in a football game. A field goal of 28 yards by Ron Valverde. And it's now Hawaii 41, the Lobos 31. Stay net with us now, won't you? 1:44 to go in the game. 41-31, Hawaii leads it. Tracy Ratowski will kick it off. Terrence Mathis will take it in the end zone and bring it out. Now he'll fake the cross-field pass. You see that in those touch football games, flag football. And then he'll head up the field to about the 18. Jim Jostrav made the tackle, a freshman. Time's running out, Gary. What do you do?
Well, you got to put the ball in the air because you have no timeouts left. So you got to put the ball in the air, and you got to throw out patterns towards the sideline, work the ball downfield. Hope you get a quick score and then can use an onside kick to regain possession to get your second score, because the Lobos do have to score twice.
65-yard drive helped by the 12 men on the field penalty that gave away the automatic first and 10 when they were going to turn the ball over to the Lobos. Garrison sacked back at the 3-yard line. The Lobos have no timeouts left. 1:25 and counting remaining. Dana Directo gets the sack.
And Directo has had quite an afternoon. Here is it. It just reached out and full length, and he caught Garrison's feet out from under him. Now Garrison will have to throw out of the end zone, and they have to go all the way out to the 28-yard line for their first.
Things wouldn't have been any better if he could have directed it. And here's the toss to Shane Hall up the field, across the 10 and to the 14. The Hawaii Rainbow Warriors will go to 1-1 in the WAC, and they'll go to 3-2 and play their next eight ball games at home. Boy, they play a lot of football games, Gary.
Well, they I think for financial reasons and so forth, you know, they can bring anybody out there. Everybody wants to go out there to play him out there, except conference teams.
Garrison now fires downfield, and it might have been picked off. They unravel, it was not. Eric Lalo was there. He and Mathis kind of stood there, and then Lalo went for it. Couldn't get a handle on it. 31 seconds remaining in the football game.
In either case, you're going to have to get the ball. You're going to have to get outside of the, or you have to get out of bounds in order to stop the clock, since you're out of timeouts.
Again, an excellent job by our crew, director, producer, camera people. Good job, some excellent shots. The Lobos will come up short again. 31 seconds to go in the football game. Penalty marker thrown, delay of game, I believe, on New Mexico. Dead shadows ball. Falling over the University lady. Stadium. Was a good homecoming crowd and a good ball game, but the Lobos had some opportunities early, Gary. They got away from them, and when you're a team that's struggling, every time that you don't take advantage of an opportunity, it will come back to haunt you, and that has been the story. And, of course, the biggest penalty was the 12 men on the field on the punt. The Lobos would have had the football with over 4 minutes and 40 seconds with good field position. What happened was it was a first and 10 after the penalty, and Hawaii took it in, got the field goal, and going to put the nails in on the top of the lid, and that was all she wrote.
Yeah, that was it. Now, that pass incompletion will bring up a fourth down. They have no choice but to try to punt it out of there.
All the people that make these broadcasts possible. We got a great spotter and statsman up here, don't we, Gary? They
we
do an
sure
excellent
do.
Job.
Mario Martinez on stats, and Randy Dietz is our spotter.
25 seconds to go. They gave the football to Hawaii. I guess it was fourth down, and they didn't get it.
Hawaii is content to run out the clock here. They have the game won.
They won't do like BYU and line up for a field goal, huh?
40, I don't think their 42nd point is that important to them.
Hey, brother.
It's all over. Hawaii has beaten the Lobos 3 of the last 4 times they've come to the Duke City, 10 out of 13 times. And Hawaii will use a great rushing attack and beat New Mexico on homecoming Saturday afternoon at University Stadium. Your final score, the University of Hawaii Rainbow Warriors 41, the University of New Mexico Lobos 31. We'll be back and wrap things up, tell you about what's coming up in the world of Lobo football right after this.